Hello, everybody on YouTube. Welcome back to my next episode of the Final Fantasy 16 Final Fantasy New Game Plus Clive Must Die Devil May Clive difficulty. If you could not tell from my voice and my general mannerisms, I am sick as shit. Last week, I finally got caught by the vid for the first time in the entirety of this pandemic. And like, I'm feeling better, but I have the cold symptoms. Like, you can tell that my voice is just not great at all. I'm all stuffy, wearing my glasses. I haven't shaved. I haven't done any workouts in like a week. And I have been just drowning in NyQuil and Aleve and Tylenol and all this other shit. So I still wanted to continue Final Fantasy 16. And I still wanted to record and stuff because I'm a madman. So that is exactly what we're gonna fucking do.
It's not a good time.
So, thank you all so much for joining me on these adventures. I do be appreciating it. And we are going to resume. And you know what? My glasses are fucking filthy. Hold on 1 second. Do I have glass cleaner or something?
No leads yet.
I thought I did.
But it's only a matter of time. Right.
Hello?
Let me know when you find something.
I could have sworn I had. Oh my god, no! Oh, not mid! Not the mid!
When did you get back?
Just now.
Oh my god, the mid COVID.
Your studies.
How fucking perfect.
Since Hugo Kupka invaded Rosaria.
I don't know where my glasses cleaner is.
He's gone mad. He's turned rogue. It'll be us next. You try concentrating with all of that.
All right.
Not gonna lie, COVID, it sucked a lot. I've been affected with a status debuff. Exactly.
Any road, while I'm here, I was hoping you could do us a favor.
I wanted to ask, how's your Street Fighter 6 journey? I haven't really played Street Fighter 6 all that much within the past like 2 weeks. I tried Rashid.
You should have a little time.
And I like him, but he's gonna take a lot of work for me to actually play effectively. But like, I literally haven't been able to play Street Fighter at all. I did a couple of like online casual matches over Wi-Fi, and I was playing with a good buddy of mine a little bit ago, like last week, last Thursday actually. So that was really nice.
Well, Clive, you heard the.
Maybe someday someone will reach out for me for my voice. You know. That would be nice actually. Maybe I can replace Ruben Langdon as Dante.
Bloody Tempest, more like.
You know!
Oi, Otto.
I wouldn't even be mad if Clive Rossfield's voice replaced Ruben Langdon. I wouldn't even be mad. I feel like that could actually work so well. Like, maybe, like, say, like, keep the gruffness, but lose the accent. And I feel like Clive's voice could make a great Dante. Are you gonna watch Evo? You know, it's funny that you mentioned that. I never really watch Evo. I browse it here and there.
Where to start?
But,
materials and tools.
Yeah, sorry. I browse it here and there, but I never actually like sit down to watch it. I've seen a couple of I'm just kind of not really that person. You know, I'd like to watch parts of it. Like, I'd like to watch the Marvel tournament for sure. Holy fucking shit. I just realized something. I just realized something. Okay. So I was originally planning on going to Evo this year because like I actually kind of had the chance to sort of. And let's then, then we kind of decided not to this year. Like, we were going to, and then we decided not to. But considering that I got, like, deathly sick with the vid, same with Amanda, it's actually kind of a blessing in disguise that I didn't pay for Evo tickets and whatnot. We're not into Evo, but Street Fighter 6 is making us interested in watching. I actually got a hard disagree with that, Phoenix. I am usually like I love Evo, but I just don't sit down and watch it. Like, I'll watch, you know, like final, like the bigger ones, but I'll never like sit and watch pools in chat. You know what I mean? Unless you're saying we, as in like you and your acquaintances, which also makes sense. Fucking wait, excuse me? Oh. You know, I kind of fucking wish I did this off stream. I kind of wish I did this off stream, because this ain't the vibe right here. I mean, overall, actually, yeah, makes sense. Yeah, I'm very excited for the Marvel tournament. Like, literally, like I said, I wanted to go to Evo this year just for Marvel alone, but like normally with my work schedule, I'm not able to. But this year, with just my current work situation, I actually had the free time, if you will, to do it. But then I just decided, like, I was talking with Amanda about it, and it's like, it would be better for us financially to not go, which was disappointing, because this is, like, the largest Evo that, I think this is the largest Evo that has ever happened. And then it has Marvel, Street Fighter, right? And just saying, like, being able to say, like, I was a part of that would have been amazing, but, I'm also perfectly fine just not going, right?
Time to fight.
I'm fine with that. But I am excited to see, like, the Marvel finals, the Street Fighter finals, and all the announcements, which I'm sure there's gonna be a bunch of cool announcements for, like, reaction videos and stuff. See, here's the thing, right? So, I want a Marvel 4, but I really don't think it's gonna happen. What I think is more likely to happen is a Capcom All-Stars game. That's actually kind of my hope, is having a Capcom All-Stars game than a Marvel vs. Capcom game. Because like, this is just me, but I'm like kind of fucking sick of Marvel and their shenanigans. And by Marvel and their shenanigans, I mean like Disney Marvel. Like, Insomniac is doing God's work right now with fucking Spider-Man. So I'm not really counting them, but I'm talking more in the sense of like Disney Marvel, like the ones who were calling all the fucking shots on like, oh, well, you need to have all of the Avengers that are in our MCU lineup in your Marvel vs. Capcom game. You need to make Captain Marvel look pretty, and fuck the X-Men, and fuck Doctor Doom, because they are just functions. Put in Captain Marvel when we release our hit movie, Captain Marvel. Like, just fucking look at the Marvel Avengers game too, right? Do I need to remind you all about Marvel's Avengers and how they put in fucking Miss Marvel for no goddamn reason? They put in Miss Marvel over fucking Hawkeye. Like, I fucked up. And I got him. Marvel was like that before Disney. That wasn't even a Disney thing. That was like a thing. I feel like Disney just made it even worse though. Cause like fucking, oh, excuse me. Because I know that before the whole Disney acquisition, Marvel was like doing a lot of whack things with Marvel vs. Capcom 3. But then when Marvel vs. Capcom 3 actually happened, I got that just in time. Holy shit. I feel like the main reason why it got delisted was because Disney just kind of said, nope, we don't want to be a part of this anymore. Yeah, Insomniac Spider-Man is Sony's business, exactly. Alright, this should be enough to kill him. Boom, shakalaka. Oh, also, here's another thing that I did the other day. I found out that I was being a silly Billy, and I didn't realize that the EXP and
that should take care
other like accessories are like they were available in the shop. So I bought them from the shop lady. And then from there, I like reinforced them. So now I'm getting a bunch of experience upgrades and stuff.
Little ones have been up to their old tricks
again. But yeah, I really like, I love Marvel vs. Capcom, but even I got to admit that like nowadays when I play Marvel vs. Capcom, I'm playing only Capcom characters. But like, unfortunately, I think that the characters that I would want to see in like a Marvel vs. Capcom game just wouldn't be included. Like, I would like Beautiful Joe back.
All right, that's no,
you know. Well, that's not why it got delisted, but like the reason it did is sort of complicated and equally stupid. A lot of Marvel games problems come from the guy who owned Marvel before Disney bought it, and that said, you can blame Disney for a lot of the aesthetic problems with Infinite. Okie dokie. Gotcha. That makes sense. I was apparently misinformed then. God damn it. I knew I should have fucking.
Let's see how Jill's faring.
Ugh. I knew I should have fucking just did those quests on my own. Because now we got two more goddamn cyclists.
Ah.
Talia.
Recovering.
Of course. Take good care.
I'll do my... Oh.
Okay, I need to talk to you. You're the med guy.
Just tell...
What you need? What you want? Give me Zero. Zero wasn't infinite. What are you talking about? Oh, do not apologize at all. Do not apologize at all. This is exactly the kind of conversations that we like having here. But nah, they... Ugh. Oh my god. They fucked Infinite up so goddamn bad that they're... See, the problem, and this is kind of the problem that I feel like was playing plaguing Nickelodeon All-Stars, is that they had a great concept, but then they just didn't fucking try hard enough for all of the things that were essential in the game. You know what I mean? It's like, good fighting will only take you so far. And I feel like that's been proven time and time again. Yeah, same with multiverses, but multiverses is a little different because my plagues with multiverses were not the
now that that's settled, I wonder if Vivian.
Sorry. Yeah, my plagues with multiverses weren't it had nothing to do with the graphics or the sounds or the gameplay itself. It was the way that the developers handled patching the game.
It's just one thing after another around here.
And then, like, you know, the rollbacks and up, like, and all, like, the huge technical issues. Whereas Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite played... Okay, actually, let me rephrase.
Have you got a minute?
I actually really liked the way that MVCI played, but I prefer the way that 3 plays. But I enjoyed MVCI. I think we had this conversation a little bit ago, and I think Cosmic was here for it. I enjoyed the way that MVCI played, but I personally enjoy 3 better. But the main plagues and issues with MVCI were the graphical quality.
You know, inside.
And like overall like quality of life, like sound and shit like that. Like the game had rollback and it played amazing online. The game could have gotten better over time with updates or even like an ultimate release. But then they released like 6 characters, had their like stupid fucking like Infinity Stone tournament, and they just said, okay, game is done. Move the fuck over, Cloud. Move the fuck over, Chris G. We're playing Street Fighter. And that's just exactly what fucking happened.
The Almechian government sues for peace. How shall we respond?
That's exactly what fucking happened with that game. And it pissed me off because I loved playing that game. And it just felt like even the people who made the game did not give a fuck about it. And that's what made me not want to support it anymore.
We have many more mouths to feed. We shall just have to have the Dalmechs empty their treasuries for us.
And then don't even get me started on fucking Nickelodeon. If you wanna hear my thoughts on Nickelodeon and All-Star Brawl 2, look at my YouTube channel. I made a video about that on Thursday before I started dying.
Indeed, I doubt any of us.
But I might have been better at MVCI than any other games. My Thanos should have team slayed. You know, it's funny that you mentioned that. I feel the exact same way. I was like, I think I was top 400 on PlayStation with Zero May Cry. And I was one of the best Marvel players in my region at the time.
Now, let us come to the question of precisely when the Dalmechs will withdraw their troops.
Dion's fire could rid us of them in mere moments.
I just realized that
the men
of
the Fist will not withdraw
shit
until a peace treaty is concluded. So let us keep the negotiations open, give them time to gather what gold and trinkets they can. And once they deliver that which we demand, what worth is a piece of parchment?
I know I said I wasn't really going to touch upon the Nickelodeon All-Star Brawl thing, but fuck it.
Enemy would surely send their own dominant to meet him.
And I love the gameplay of Nazba,
there would be heavy losses on both.
You need not fear Hugo.
It also looked like a mess.
He is engaged on the Western Front, even were the Dalmechs to send for him.
But I think the biggest slap in the face is that they had rollback netcode.
Witnessing a clash between Bahamut and Titan.
The netcode had so many issues, like they weren't fucking prepared. With the netcode, so the netcode actually turned bad. Like it had good netcode for like a day, and then as like the game progressed, the netcode just got worse.
There will be losses, it is true. Yet for every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built.
And I think that, like, my thoughts on Nazba 2 have changed a little bit. Because, it looks like this game is going to be correcting all of the mistakes that the old game had. But then the problem just becomes, like... Actually, here's my predictions. The game comes out in October... It comes out in about 2 months. I don't fucking think that game is gonna sell well. At all. I don't think it's gonna sell well. Because I feel like everybody who bought it initially is gonna look at it and say, fuck that, and not buy it, regardless on if it looks better or not. Because it's gonna be like a full priced game again. Well, I say full price, but it was the same price as the first one, like $50. But it's coming out in fucking October. when, like, Mortal Kombat's coming out, when Spider-Man's coming out, when fucking Assassin's Creed and, like,
Sire.
Like, what are they doing?
Do not make me repeat myself.
I actually don't understand why they're releasing it in October. I think that this is just my subjective opinion, but I think that's a dumb idea. I think it's really dumb that they're releasing it in October.
If that is your wish, your radiance.
I think if they waited until like January, the game would sell much better. That's just my opinion. Oh, yeah. What are Switch owners buying in October? Mortal Kombat 1.
May Gregor forgive you.
If you like Mortal Kombat, Mortal Kombat 1. Yeah, Mortal Kombat 1's on the Switch, right? Right?
What do the astrologers augur?
The stars are in agreement, your radiance.
I don't know how it's gonna run, but it's on the Switch. I'm pretty sure that my cousin had Infinite on his Xbox. We had no idea what we were doing or what was happening.
So Annabella's tales were true. You disappoint me, Dion.
Yeah, apparently Mortal Kombat 1 can run on the... Like, MK11's also on the Switch as well. And I mean, like, MK1 is also going to be on PS4 and the old Xbox as well. So, like, it should stand to reason that it would run on the Switch. I just imagine that it's going to kind of have the same issues that that Street Fighter 6 kind of has in comparison to, like, you know, PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4. It's going to be obvious what the better version of the game to play on is going to be. I was listening to the Triple KO podcast where Justin Wan was saying how he played MK. No, sorry, not MK. He played Street Fighter 6 on a PS4 for like a tournament, and it was like a night and day, completely different game. And like I've played Street Fighter 6 on a PS4, and I don't think it was that exaggerated, but I could definitely feel somewhat of a difference.
Not being able to tell you more, I hadn't the faintest idea. Kupka withdrew wounded from.
It's the best way to play an NPC. It's fun when you don't know what you're doing.
My own nephew dealt the decisive blow.
Nah, see, the best way to play in Marvel vs. Capcom,
I think,
is to get someone who has absolutely no idea what they're doing, and then you hit him with zero loops. Funniest shit ever. hit him with the good old ZMC tech. Or THC infinites. And that's when they pull the invincible meme where they're like when am I allowed to have fun? That's the fun part. You're not.
Certainly her Royal Navy is famed for the efficiency.
So what's your ideal Capcom All-Star roster?
And in the Einherja or Black Galleon, she boasts swift. And every bit as feared as the kingdom's legendary.
That's a good question, actually.
A fitting flagship.
I know for sure that I want Leon Kennedy somewhere in there. He deserves to be there. Like Resident Evil 4, Leon Kennedy.
Safe to assume that the royalists did indeed.
I want Beautiful Joe. I want God Hand. I want Asura's Wrath.
Had you a vested.
Bionic Commando can get out of here. Actually, you know what? Nah, keep Bionic Commando.
Why home to Drake's
if we're allowed to have God Hand, Asura's Wrath, and Beautiful Joe, we can keep Spencer.
But would that not entail an arduous voyage around the Southern Cape?
Dante, like said, Virgil, Nero. With a mind to spirit, Kupka, I wouldn't mind Lady or Trish, but maybe not both.
To load him aboard one of the ships flying Republican colors sighted off the coast near Port Isolde.
I think what would be really cool would be a
unforgiving waves,
like not like exo, like not an exoprimal, like an exoprimal rep.
No.
Where it's like one person, it's like the exoprimal dude, but like he can swap suits. I think that shit would be really cool. Like you have three, like you have like three or four characters in one where like he can like quickly change in the suit and then like do something. That would be really fucking cool.
A party traveling light would have tightened.
I don't know about her. Could lurch into port. I feel like she hasn't done a whole lot.
The Republicans who affected Hugo Kupka's safe retreat. I would stay.
I would personally keep Wesker and Nemesis, and maybe add Jack Baker, probably.
So it was the Walludas who spirited the wretch away.
Now hey, what's up, Byron? How you doing? There was hey, look, there he is. He's right there. He's Byron. The ships I saw. Ethan Winters. How the fuck are they gonna add Ethan Winters? How the fuck would they add Ethan Winters? It's finished out. They would just have like a black shadow on his face. No
little Otto.
That'd be Cooper's really funny. Thing.
You're not going in there.
Don't worry. I won't risk any
plans around if you have any trouble.
Who is she?
An old associate of Sid's. We've heard
that. Don't get
okay. He'd be in this stupid machine he uses to fight Eisenberg. That'd be really funny. Street Fighter 6 Ken. I would like Ken to come back into Marvel 3. Because, like, he would have, like, his own unique moveset. I would like that. Oh, we need Luke. Luke needs to be in Street Fighter. No, he needs to be in the new Marvel game. Rival schools, yeah. Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot of possibilities that we can have. But, like, I'm thinking of, like... I just think of, like, whenever I think of, like, my favorite Capcom IPs, like... I was actually playing Beautiful Joe the other day, and I was like, fuck, I missed this game. Up you go, fella! I fucking miss Beautiful Joe. You know, let me rephrase it. I miss Beautiful Joe in his old voice. I think that the Marvel 3 Beautiful Joe voice is so stupid. I've always hated it. I've always hated it. And hearing Beautiful Joe's voice in the first game just reminded me of that. JP and Ed, get no. Phoenix, no. Absolutely not. I refuse.
Let's go. Run like the wind.
JP needs to fuck off everywhere for the rest of my life. He doesn't deserve it.
Beyond the ruins. Welcome well, Clive.
I will take Street Fighter 6 and Street Fighter 5 Luke over one JP. Mega Man EX key character. Oh yeah, that'd be cool too. Although I feel like everybody would want X.
Accompanying your father on a scouting expedition to Drake's Fang.
He let me come with you.
I'm not surprised you don't remember. It was just before
I'm trying to think of who else.
You were so eager to be there when your brother arrived that you whipped your chocobo too hard on the journey home and fell from the saddle.
Oh, a fucking monster hunter.
I'll never forget how Elwin.
We need monster hunter back. Sand,
bawling like a baby.
That's another one.
Who do you think those songs?
I think having V as a fighting game character would be really cool. He would have a really weird and unique moveset, like a puppet moveset. I would really enjoy that. Like, I imagine V playing like a fucking Storm puppet character.
Do you know, this heat has given me
I wouldn't care if he's good or not. I would just want that. A V, like a puppet character in a Capcom Tag Fighter. He doesn't even need to be good. I just want to see it. Okay. I actually need to grab like a trash bag or something and blow my nose. I'm sorry. Give me like 2 seconds. All right, Ali, stay.
Look there.
Good boy.
Those are Ashen steeds. No doubt about it.
And such a long ride from Stonehair. Our Waluda friends must be soothing their saddle sores in the inn. Shall we join them?
Yeah, sorry for leaving, but this was like something that I needed.
Run along and play now, Torgal.
I also apologize if this is gonna be gross, but I absolutely need to blow my nose. Jesus. Hey, Byron. There's only one person allowed to call me that. And I hope to meet them in maybe like 5 years. Bro, could have just muted them. Oh, you're right. I probably could have. Whoops. Metal Gear Rising Raiden. Hey, Reaping, how's it going? How are you?
Good day to you. Eating?
Well, actually, you know what? I just realized now is probably the time that I can take this.
He only talks when his mouth's full. What do you recommend?
Oh boy, here we go.
Well, if you're after something, it's light, or not NyQuil. Soup with lentils.
Fuck,
and
if
honey?
I took NyQuil right now. What is that, then? An ale. Cheers.
Right, you are.
Hey, girl.
Coming.
Your pal.
Would you rather be my squire?
What about guest characters? Actually, yo, hold on. Phoenix, Wolverine being a guest character would be fucking like next level, right? Like, he's the only Marvel character that's allowed to come back. Sleep schedule's messed up, so I just woke up. Makes sense. Hey, Burrito, what's good? Hello, hello. Be kind of a slap in the face, though. Nah, I think it'd be funny. One Marvel character in a Capcom All-Stars game. I think that'd be funny. Well enough to finally beat the game a few days ago, 10 out of 10. Love to see it. Good shit. No, congratulations.
We must press on. Prince Theon has returned to his
camp. I'm so glad that now we can talk about how when Clive went to fight Ultima, a portal opened up and goddamn Shrek came out and punched God in the face. Fucking amazing.
Yes, Your Grace. You must at least agree to take your medicine.
Yeah, Clive. You know, yeah, bring Clive. Clive would be allowed to come in. Speaking of which, let me just fucking... Oh, let me fucking... There is no escape! Bro, these guys have a lot of fucking health on them. What the? Byron, what the fuck are you doing, dude? Oh, I don't even have Torgal with me. Oh yeah, you fucking thought that was gonna do something? Huh? You fucking thought? You fucking thought, buddy? Oh yeah, what the fuck you gonna do, Royal Osphere? What the fuck you gonna do? Oh, he actually did hit me. Bitch. He's gonna live through this. Oh no, he actually did die. Wait, is your wife pregnant? No, but we are engaged, so we're almost at the wife stage. Almost. Congrats on your engagement. Thank you so much, Burrito. Yes, we are engaged. We got engaged last Sunday, which was fucking amazing. And then 2 days later, Amanda caught COVID.
What the hell is this?
Word of advice, miss. That soup could be a touch more salt.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is why you don't get engaged. Is there much you can do with Torgal's super mode in this game? No. Not really. Not really, unfortunately. Like, Torgal Super Mode.
We didn't know where to find Kupka before. We do now.
I gotta be completely real with you.
Themselves.
I don't know.
The guest is in the fang.
Like, I don't pay attention to what any of my party members are doing. Torgal doesn't even heal me unless I ask him to. So I don't know. It took me 3 to 5 work days to figure it out after you said someone that can call you daddy will meet you in about 5 years. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, apparently engagements give COVID now. Apparently.
Light it for Gilbert's sake.
Why would you? Yeah, exactly. I could just, like, I could watch, like, fucking Jill or whoever just do negative damage to an enemy while I clear
anything
an entire
I can help
room.
You with, Travelers?
Allow me.
Yeah,
my
I.
Good man.
Yeah, I started using Precision Sick and Ravage a lot more after I realized how useful they were.
What do you want?
What do you want? I just want to progress through the game without having to do all these side quests.
Sprig is the person we're looking for. You said Sid's contact was likely to
but
be
it's such a bad RPG.
Sort.
It's a great character acting game,
influence
but the equipment and the party members.
And
yeah, no, the party members
believe you me.
Are like barely there. But the combat,
wait,
though.
I want to play with the crystal.
But the combat, though. I will say, though, when it comes to the equipment, I love the way that the equipment
well,
is done in this game.
Like
only because I played Eishin before I played this, and I
let's
fucking
and
hated
exactly
it.
What this photo knows.
I fucking hated the way the equipment and crafting system was.
Excuse me.
But I also think that, the crafting gets even better in New Game Plus.
Him? Only as far as I think he drove.
Alright, and they're like, oh, we have deceived you, and I'm gonna fucking kill these guys. Oh, let me just fucking... There is no escape. Nope, Clive, nope, I didn't want you to do that. What? Oi! Stop fucking teleporting, you idiot!
Shiva!
And they're gonna fucking die again. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my Final Fantasy 16 Final Fantasy New Game Plus speedrun. Just fucking... just do that over and over again and that's how you win the game. So I haven't crafted everything. Yeah, you get a lot of crafting materials. You get a lot of crafting materials in this game. I realized that I had so many crafting materials that it actually started automatically discarding them because I had so many.
Needed to a silken softness.
The most fragrant herbs
the finest fabric.
Skip this. And then I remembered that guy.
Don't tell me.
Look at him in his smug ass smile.
I thought we were the only ones causing trouble in Delamil.
Oh fuck, that's right, I gotta do all these. Alright, speedrun, here we go. Nope. He took too long turning around, so I skipped it. I wish I had more stuff to spend money on besides getting everyone at the hideout hammer. You know, I actually realized that I haven't done that either. I should probably do that. See, what I actually wanted to do is I wanted to, because I was expecting... Like, if I bought all of the music, then I would get an achievement for it, but that's not an achievement, so now I have no reason to actually spend money on it.
I wonder wonder if Uncle...
Once you go flat...
They'll probably be back at the inn by now.
The finest fabric!
Oh, goal three, good shit. Alright, let me talk to this lady.
Why is the tavern shut?
Speed run! She took too long turning. She took too long turning, so I just skipped it. And then Byron is over here. Yeah, I ain't getting that plat, though. Honestly, like... After, like, I could... But I just don't really want to. Because I feel like you don't need to do everything in the game in order to get the platinum. Let me... You know what? It's going to be faster if I do this. It's so fucking crazy how I can just reload the map just like that. And then suddenly, boom, it's faster. Shit is nutty. And I love it. The power of the PlayStation 5. She. Yeah, the loading speed just... Burrito, I'm so glad that you finished this game so we can actually talk about it in depth now. It's so great. But yeah, like, the load speeds are fucking amazing. They're so good. I actually did mention this before, and I will mention it again. I would like to do a third playthrough on my own eventually when I get, like, a huge 4K television. Just so I can play the game on graphics mode and just lose my shit when I play this game. So we're all in agreement, Clive? Nah, Clive, I still think that... it's so hard because it's like there's so much... speculation
from here,
but I personally just like the idea that Clive died. Oh, please, thank you, Clive. No, thank you. I think it is possible that Clive lived, but I would much prefer if he was dead.
It's not over yet, Uncle. Good. I'm just
kidding. Oh, look at this guy. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him just fucking walk up there thinking he can do something. Look at him. Look at how fucking cute that is. Bitch. Yeah, fucking cure that, bitch. Let me fucking... Oh my god. Clive, stop! Stop fucking... whatever. Is there more? Oh, there's more. Oh, take this, you bird. I fucking love ignition so much. Nope. Hold on. I'm canceling that shit. There we go. And then bird. It's over. They definitely have an open end for a reason, but a lot of the side quests and stuff make Clive survive. Yeah, exactly. That's why I'm kind of like, I'm in that like in between where I'm like, is it possible that Clive is alive? Absolutely. Do I want him to be alive? No. Like, the only reason I would want Clive to be alive would be like, my own selfish reason of like, oh my god, I fucking love this character so much and I want to see more of him. But like,
any friend of mine,
and like knowing that he kind of got his happy ending, but I think it's just,
thank you, Lubo.
And please,
the impact of the ending was a lot stronger for me because he died. Or at least I thought he died, you know.
Dalamil is back in bed with Sid.
Excuse me. Hedwig. Hello, Hedwig.
To his Achilles.
Okay. I wasn't loving the Senzu Tsukin gimmick when I got it. Stuck to the Mega Flare nonsense. Interesting. Yeah, because I'm the exact opposite. I do not like Mega Flare. I think that getting Mega Flare is so slow. But I'm also trying. But I also think that, like, just doing what I'm doing, which is doing the Xan tech, is just a little bit boring. But it just does so much fucking damage.
Well then.
Like, it screen clears fucking everything. It's so powerful. Mega Flare is just too slow for me. But doing the Xan thing, like the Lightning Rod Xan tech, is so good. But it just does so much fucking damage. But my problem is that, like, I would actually prefer doing sorry. Nope. Too long. I would much prefer using Titan. But the problem with Titan is that the blocking is so fucking gimmicky for me that I can't rely on it, especially in a game like, especially in the game mode like this.
Trust Lubor to take a simple test.
I see.
I better get to it.
The finest fabric.
That reminds me. Hold on. I've been meaning to switch. Just for the fuck of it.
Good sir, needed to a silken soft.
Yeah, I would love to keep the Titan parry on for the whole game, but he's taking too long to turn around. But like I said, the parry gimmick,
all right,
it just feels really weird in this game to me for some reason. However, that's kind of why I've been reserving Titan for, like, boss fights that I know I'm going to enjoy the fight. Rather than, just relying on Xan. Also, while I'm here, I may as well do that other thing. I'm gonna skip this. Oh shit. Yeah, I actually never, you know what? Just for the hell of it. Let me fucking, oh. Never mind.
Come on, shall we press on?
Yeah. I've been meaning to try it, but I haven't been able to because I've just been sticking with my Xan tech. Oh, wait, did I? Okay, it is back here. Since it's over here and it's gonna take me like 2 seconds to clear that room, I may as well do it. Hello there.
By the flames. That explains the heat.
Let me just fucking do this. Now stay right here, Clive, you motherfucker. No! You know I'm fine, whatever.
Out of the frying pan.
Yeah, I've never used this before, so let's see what happens. I feel like I did that incorrectly. Yeah, I totally did that incorrectly. What the fuck? playing my loadout right now. I got 6 icons on it. Shit. Oh, absolutely. Let me fucking. Oh, you bitch. Sending me to the shit. Yo, Torgo, you wanna fucking heal me, dog? Bahamut satellite, Giga Flare, Ramu, Will of the Lakes. See about Razor Fist lined up. Oh, so you're not even using, you're not even using, like, the Titan, like, Royal Guard block. You're just using the parry move. Interesting. Oh, nope. All right, let me fucking... Don't you fucking kill me. Yeah, fuck you, bitch.
Too much for Rossfield!
No match for the Rossfields.
Let's hope it's enough to keep the baths from boiling.
Oh wait, let me pick this up first. All right, where's my horse? Yeah, horsey.
Run like the wind.
Just kick that weary traveler. He's gonna be more weary now. And I only have one potion because I wasted the rest of them. Okay. What the fuck is I gonna do? I'm gonna make for Drake's Fang and I'm gonna beat the shit out of Hugo is what I'm gonna do. Oh my god, I have like no fucking potions.
Drake's Fang.
You know, Drake's Fang sounds like a Yu-Gi-Oh card.
Kupka will be hiding inside.
I got the lightning rod equipment on it along so I can shred their life with mega. Oh my god, yeah, lightning rod is so busted.
You'll need to keep your wits about you if you're to reach him. So be careful.
I will, Uncle.
Yo, can we just acknowledge for a second that Byron
before you go,
found out
Clive,
that both of his nephews,
apologize.
One after another, were alive, and then lost them in the
after
same fucking
befell
week?
At Phoenix Gate and the crisis that followed in its wake, I fled.
That shit is so
I
fucking
retreated
tragic.
To my counting house and danced attendance upon the.
I feel so bad for this poor old man.
I betrayed my nation to save my skin, like the coward I am.
Yo, Sam.
And I'm sorry.
You know what's crazy? Really, the only people that died in the game were the two main characters and Sid.
Clive.
Like, the only, like, protagonists.
And there are those that would
help and side characters.
Back. Had I
they were the only ones that died.
I might already have done so, but that ship has sailed.
The you one character that I didn't want know. To die fucking died.
Forgive
have you played
me,
Jump
I
Force?
Cannot.
I actually do have it. I've played it a couple times.
To build a new world now.
Isn't Jump Force supposed to get delisted, like,
world.
This year? Or was that
men
last
can live
year?
And die on their own terms. I... was raised in a nation that strove to improve the plight of bearers.
Oh yeah, no, same here, Burrito. I actually did think that Jill was gonna die. And then, and then that's where Clive would get her powers.
That spark of freedom did not arise.
Fuck, this is how we get Shiva.
By my father.
Exactly.
You would see me follow in his footsteps. And that is exactly what I mean to do.
Yeah, I was afraid that we would get Shiva by Jill dying. But then we got it in a more satisfying way. The twins.
Though every soul in the
I think it already got the servers down last year. Damn. Yeah, because I still have it. I bought it for like $5.
You really are just like him, you know? Thank you, Clive, for coming back to me. I am proud to call you nephew.
And I am oh shit, I can't do that voice now.
Well then, this is where we must part ways.
One ticket to Bobby, please.
My Canvarian friend to share his concern.
That was nowhere near what I wanted it to be.
I mean, one to ticket. His coffers
I give up.
And prove myself worthy of a place in your merry band.
When baby Joshua grabbed Clive's finger, I felt then, that.
My boy.
Till then. Go safely, uncle.
And you, nephew. We have much to catch up on, you and I. I should expect you to regale me with the tales of all your adventures when next we meet.
And then I basically flawless Ultima.
You can regale me too.
You mean Shrek, Google. Flawless Ultima. Remember, Shrek is the one that did all the work.
I'm coming for you, Kupka.
Donkey precision sick on Ultima. Hold on. Before we go through the best boss fight in the game, I gotta pee real fast. So, give me like 2 seconds. Give me like 2 seconds. Oliver, you entertain everybody. Don't say something that'll get me canceled. Let's fucking punch Titan right in the face. Good boy. You know, I gotta say, out of everybody in our household, the person I feel the worst for is Oliver. Oliver has had to deal with 2 sick parents. So he's been going back and forth. Your cute pupper said mayonnaise isn't an instrument. No, Patrick. Mayonnaise is not an instrument. At least I can still do a Squidward impression.
Out of my sight, witch!
Horseradish is not an instrument either.
I'll kill you,
bro, fucking Squidward tentacles and Nickelodeon All-Star Brawl too.
You limb from limb.
Peace, Hugo.
Did not think that we would see the timeline where we would get both a Nazbah 2 and Squidward in the same timeline, but here we are.
He would be dead.
You truly believe you would have triumphed at the battle?
I would love Squidward's wave dash noise to be his, like, huh, so he could go, ha 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 ha, as he's fucking wave dashing across the screen. Can you just imagine that? Just yourself a dominant. Hey, speaking of Nazbah too, it's Avi, Nazbah's biggest fan, right there. How you doing, Avi?
Do you see, Hugo?
As soon as I saw that fucking trailer, she was the first person I sent it to.
But But so long as that fire burns within
you... Oh my god, you know what? While you're here, hold on.
There may yet be a way for you to take your revenge.
Because I keep fucking forgetting to do this, and I've been sick for the past, like, year, so...
What must I do? Please, I'll do anything. Just... tell me.
There we go. I changed the lurk god command to lurk goddess.
What of it?
It took me like 2 seconds. And I kept forgetting to do it, but I did it. There we go.
Perhaps.
Yeah, you were really good at that game, especially with Cat Dog.
The crystal would not yield her blessing to any ordinary man. But then.
Yeah. Like, I am interested in seeing more of it, but, like, I just don't want to fucking pay $50 for it in October.
And others have suffered a similar fate, and still...
I really think that the game would do better if it's sold in January. I really would. Actually, you know what? Hold on.
Like Benedicta Harmon.
Nazbah 2? Or, fuck.
Drank of the ether. Gained a power beyond human understanding.
Excuse me?
She did.
Fucking... Oh my god, I don't care about the cookies. No, I'm not disabling ad blocker. Go away. It's fucking releasing October 24th. Oh, MK is releasing in September. I didn't realize that. Fucking Nazbah 2 has the same release date as Spider-Man.
Run along now, Hugo. You need only follow the light.
Who the fuck does SpongeBob SquarePants think he is? Never forget when I stream sniped Maggie. Beat her twice in a row and then lost the subsequent 90 games.
You may leave everything to me, Your Majesty.
Meiji? Magi? Sorry. It just hit me that games with long cutscenes are broken for streaming because you can just chill and talk. Actually, Avi, it is a bit of a double-edged sword. So, like, the reason why I'm able to, like, chill and talk at the moment is because I've already seen all of these cutscenes, so I don't really need to pay attention to them. But, like, when you're actually playing it, it becomes a little more difficult trying to concentrate on both. However, the worst of it is fucking Yakuza. Yakuza cutscenes seem like they're very good for streaming. But the fact that you have the Japanese dub with English subtitles that you have to look at and read and process while you were also talking to chat makes it so fucking hard. So I agree with you to a certain extent. In a case like this, it is absolutely broken. But, and then not to mention that you have Smoke and Six style gameplay in between.
Orcs.
But yeah, so anyways, like,
are the beastmen part?
I want
the army
to
now?
Be excited for Nazbah 2, but I just happen? I'm just not excited for it as I feel like I should be. Let me fucking and let's see what happens if I do this. Oh, shit! Yeah, fuck you, bitch. Yeah, we fucking take those! Yeah, we absolutely need to hang out very soon, Avi. I miss you too. Although, it'll probably be a little bit longer until we can hang out again because, I don't know if you saw, but Amanda and I caught the vid. Oh, this is fucking perfect, because then I can just, yo, that's a fucking cute ability, bravery, yeah. How brave.
So much for the men of the rock.
We're fucking speedrunning through this shit, baby. Let's go. Oh yeah, that's right. It does heal. I totally forgot about that. You both feeling okay? So we're feeling better now. So basically what ended up happening and okay, I'll go through the whole thing again because I know that a lot of people missed it the first time. So what ended up happening is Amanda and I got engaged on Sunday, right? And then Monday, she started not feeling so great, like at night. She tested positive for COVID on Tuesday and we kind of like secluded ourselves and whatever. She definitely got the worst of it. But then we actually ended up going to the ER on Thursday because she ended up getting like a prescription that was supposed to help her. And it didn't really, it didn't really help her at all. Like it had like really bad side effects. So she was really dehydrated and we ended up going to the ER. And then I tested positive on Friday after I wasn't really feeling that great like Thursday. She's feeling a lot better right now, but like we're just kind of concerned at the moment of like possible like you know, other symptoms and whatnot. Like she was really concerned about like you know, her kidney because she had a really bad kidney infection a couple years ago, among like a bunch of other issues. So that's the main thing that we're just kind of monitoring right now. Where it's like, bitch, all the like bigger like symptoms and side effects that could happen because of COVID. I feel much better now, but I've just had like cold symptoms the entire time. So, well, like I've had cold symptoms now. Like I have really bad cold symptoms now. But I had the chills, muscle aches, and everything on Friday. So it's just kind of more of a like, we really hope that it doesn't get worse for Amanda. But yeah. Oh, you saw Bruce at Gommel? That's funny. Yeah, Bruce came in here on Monday, actually. I hadn't talked to him in a while. Saying like congratulations for Amanda and I. Uh-oh. Missed. There we go. Okay, come on. Four. Oh, am I still in range? I am. Holy shit, that did a lot. And this should kill him. Bruce said something hilarious regarding you. Oh, Jesus. Wait, can I go? I'm gonna go in here first. I don't know what's in here. Oh, thank God. Wait, Torgol, hear me. No, Torgol isn't healing me.
Now I'm a little motivated.
I'm hurt, Torgol. Oh, hello.
You should never have left Ash.
Whoa. I just realized something. I'm being stupid. I need to... Where are you? These aren't normal encounters. So I'm gonna fucking... That's dumb. Whatever.
Stay down.
Who the fuck? Someone's doing something. Who is it? It's you! Oh, fuck! Let me fucking do this, actually.
Not good.
Not good. I should've just did that from the start. Oh, fucking Christ. Because I need to talk to my friend. There's a local tonight. Ooh, nice. Well, good luck in the local. You need to come to quit your friendlies. I actually can't come to quit your friendlies.
Forgive me.
Shit. Yeah, I actually can't come to quit your friendlies. Because that day is actually our foster daughter's birthday celebration. I was actually supposed to help run Quit Your Friendlies too, but I can't, unfortunately. And then, now that I think about it, if there was something on Sunday, now I can't even go on Sunday because I have another event thing going on. Come here. And another! Oh. How many deaths so far? I have not been keeping track, Arsen. But we've had a lot more deaths on this difficulty than we have on the other one. Oh. Alrighty, have fun, Evie. Don't forget to make good choices and yeah. Yeah, we've had a fair amount of deaths.
Stairs. This must be the way out.
Oh, there's a dude there. Stinger! Yeah, Byron, just put it under creative. Or creative or self promo. What are these good choices that you speak of? Don't catch the vid. That is the best choice that I could probably ask that anybody make. Learn from my mistake. Don't do anything ever. Uh-oh.
I'm sneaking past this one.
Ah, shit!
How did it get in here?
I fucking hit that counter. Try it again. Oh! I will admit that I did not hit that counter. Oh, bitch! Fuck out of here. Oh god. Where are you going? Stinger! Go, Targo!
Get him!
Bitch! I still got hit anyways. I was the bitch all along. Bro, that did so much stagger to him. Holy shit. Yeah, fuck you, buddy! Eat shit! I can't see shit. Oh, I fucked up. I can't see either. So you know what? It's okay. Uh-oh. Ow. Bitch. Are you winning? I'd like to think so. Let me hit him with this. Oh, fucking A! Excuse me? Oh my god, this fucking video game. Alright, and then let me cancel that right there. I feel like I don't need a Zan to kill him. I'll save it. He's dead. See what I tell you, I didn't need the Zan. Bodied. Anyways. Torgal, where are we going? Thank you, Torgal. RE4 remake is so damn good. It really is. That's what Arsene's currently playing. My seventh playthrough of RE4 remake. I also want to do another RE4 remake playthrough, but on like 4K Ultra HD. Wallet breaking expensive television combo playthrough. Pikmin 4 sold more than Final Fantasy 16. That sounds about right because it's on the Switch and it's rated E. But if I'm telling you right now which game is gonna win Game of the Year, it's totally going to be Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, because I can't have anything nice in this world. Oh, sorry, not Breath of the Wild. Breath of the Wild 2. Excuse me. They're the same thing. They're the same thing. You know what I meant. You know what I meant. Where's the... You know what I need? I need a boo sound effect. Yeah, Tears of the Kingdom. I'm sure that Tears of the Kingdom will probably win Game of the Year this year. Too many fucking... You know, too many great games came out this year. And it's just me, because it's just me, but like... So many great games came out this year that I can't wait for fucking Breath of the Wild 2 to win Game of the Year this year. Ow. I don't need to fucking heal. It's fine. I don't need to heal. Yeah, you fucking hit that corner, dude. Oh my god. Holy shit! Oh my god, he might actually die from all this shit. Also, what's up, Evan? How you doing? Yeah, I know that Tears of the Kingdom was pretty incredible, but like, I could see why it would win Game of the Year, but it's like, oh, I accidentally used potions. I didn't mean to do that. I meant to have Torgal sick him, but I'll take it, I guess. Oh, fuck! It's like I'm playing Mario Party. Yeah, I'm also happy that Bayonetta won one of the Game Awards from last year. If Zelda wins, I will consider it one of the biggest robberies of this year for an award history. You know, I know that it, like, the whole Game of the Year thing is all subjective, but I gotta agree with you there, Burrito. So many fucking great games came out this year, but like, and I understand that, but like, y'all know me, I'm not a big Zelda fan. But, like, I just think that so many fucking absolutely beautiful games came out this year. Oh, God. Oh, shit. Let me fucking do this real fast. Do I have another Zan? I do. Come on! I don't know how much damage this is actually gonna do. Oh, goddamn. Yeah. Who was it that was talking about, like, the, you know, what Super Torgel does? Look at fucking Super Torgel right there. Look at him doing all of that whole lot of nothing. Oh, fuck! Shit! Oh, that better not hit me. He's gonna die. Speaking of great games, we've seen the extra promo, got my whole friend group. That's awesome, Evan! I love to hear it.
It's over.
I was actually playing Exoprimal a little bit the other day. They have a new, like, game mode called the Savage Gauntlet, but apparently you have to beat the main story to play it, so I've been trying to grind out the main story. Like, and here's the thing, right? Like, Arsene, like, I understand why Tears of the Kingdom is, like, a 10 out of 10, like, great game, like, game of the year contender, and will probably win game of the year, just being real. But it's just, like, I just think that, like,
expected.
It's just me, because it's just, like, I just don't really enjoy those types of games.
So,
and I feel like
the power of Muthos.
So much great achievement has happened from, like, games like Hi-Fi Rush or Final Fantasy 16. It could also just be my bitter resentment towards Nintendo that makes me not want to do it, but, like, you know, I get it. I would much rather see Hi-Fi Rush or Final Fantasy 16 win Game of the Year. Like, as much as I would love Hi-Fi Rush to win Game of the Year, it's not gonna win Game of the Year. There is... If Hi-Fi Rush wins Game of the Year, I will fucking do an 808 cosplay. I remember the day Gamers was thirsting over Ganon. Yeah, you just gotta watch Terminal Montage's Ganon video. That shit's hilarious. Let me fucking... I better get... There we go. But yeah, like I said, nothing against anybody who enjoys Tears of the Kingdom. Cause, like, I was watching footage and I'm like, I can see the appeal. I see why this is a fun game and, like, you know, 10 out of 10 game of the year contender. But, like, I just personally wouldn't find enjoyment in it, and that's why I'm like, yeah. I think it's also just, like, the bitter resentment where I'm like, of course fucking all these great games come out the same year as Hi-Fi Rush. Like, I'm a little mad that Final Fantasy 16 came out the same year as Hi-Fi Rush. Because so help me God, if Hi-Fi Rush doesn't win a single award this year, I will shit a chicken.
Are these things here for me? Or for him?
Oh, this fucking bitch. Don't you fucking attack me off screen, you bitch. You attack me from off screen. I don't know if I got hit from that. Where's this other fucking guy? Oh, I fucked up. Bitch. Really? Fine. Fuck you. I'll fucking deal with you first then. Oh shit.
Not good.
Get the fuck out of here.
Come on.
All right, let me fucking. Just finished by the server screen. I gotta say, I loved it. That's awesome. Yeah, fuck you, buddy! Fuck you!
You're finished.
Oh, whoops. Heading to Lowe's now, you sound better. I'm shocked. Shocked, I tell you, Amanda. Cause I feel like I don't
first
sound better.
Now these nightmares. Is this your doing, Ultima?
I feel like I just feel like lower energy. Stinger! Stinger! Ow. Get the fuck out of here. I'll use these potions, whatever. Oh yeah, I took my knife bolt. Yeah, fuck you, buddy.
To me, boy.
Ow. Ow. I'm trying to do cool stuff. Leave me alone. I just wanted to try to do cool shit. Leave me alone. Did I say NyQuil? Yeah, so you can tell where I'm at right now. I sound better in here, but up here, it tells a different story. All right. Let's fucking try this again. Oh, I can't believe I got that. Alright, hit him with. No escape. No escape! No escape! Fine! Bro, fuck. I just wanted to hit you with the no escape. Why are you streaming then? Why are you working? Fuck you! I missed. Oh, you bitch. I'm taking this. All right, let me hit that. Let me hit. Was the strength debuff? Yeah, no, it has been not cool. However, I will say though, the main benefit of catching the vid is that I finally had an excuse to start watching The Boys. And you know what? That show is fucking incredible. I love it. I wish I watched this show years ago. And it has confirmed to me that I'm going to be maining Omni-Man in Mortal Kombat instead of Homelander. another bitch. Bro, he fucking just sat there and let me do it. I fucking missed again. Fuck you. Bitch. Hit him with the booyah. Bitch. Anyways. Nope, that was the wrong door. Fucking. You know what? Torgo, where am I supposed to go? I'm dumb. There we go. Yeah, I'm sure I'll get MK1 eventually. Are you gonna watch the new TMNT movie? Absolutely not. I already know for a fact that movie is not for me, so I will not be watching it.
Busy Kupka.
Unfortunately, as much as I absolutely love the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles,
where did you go?
I'm good. I'm good with that. The last... When... What was the last Ninja Turtles media that I enjoyed? I feel like the last time I enjoyed a Ninja Turtles project was TMNT.
The Heart.
I feel like that was the last time I really enjoyed an official, like, Ninja Turtles project that didn't have anything to do with, like, a crossover or anything like that.
Come on, Togo.
Oh, I better be able to get back in here. There we go. The Nickelodeon show was fine, but it just, again, I didn't really watch it all that much. The bits that I saw on TV were fine, but, like, the 2000s cartoon was my, like, upbringing, which, fun fact, is also the main reason why I actually began my journey as a martial artist was because of that TV show. It has my favorite version of Casey Jones, my favorite version of, like, all of the Ninja Turtles. And then the TMNT movie I really enjoyed.
Just what I did.
Did Clive illusion? No, not yet. Do I have a Xan? I don't. Yo, fucking Shredder for MK1 would be so rad. Can I fucking get this? Thank you. See, now, here's the thing, though. Shredder for MK1, but I once again have to reiterate that it's gotta be the 2000s Shredder. 2000s Shredder was a goddamn fucking menace. That Shredder is also my favorite version of Shredder. He was a fucking menace for a fucking 4Kids CW cartoon. And goddamn Oroku Saki. Oh, man. Literally the best. I feel like I'm playing Devil May Cry right now.
Get him.
Oh, that's cute.
Better be the last of them.
Yeah, I think the best part about that Shredder too is that, like, he just kept fucking coming back. Like, they would kill him. Like, they would kill him. They fucking killed this man on a 4Kids television show so many goddamn times. They K-worded him many times. but he would keep fucking coming back. That Shredder was a goddamn menace.
I swear to you, my love.
My mom associates you with the purple TMNT. Amanda, I want you to name all of the Ninja Turtles right now. You're not getting any help from me. I want you to name all of the Ninja Turtles. Exactly, Marie. They had Leo decapitate him. I was literally thinking that. They fucking decapitated Shredder on live television. It was literally as graphic as this scene right here on a fucking children's show. They decapitated him.
Oh shit.
I'm pretty sure they... Oh my god, what else did they fucking do? I think he blew up in a spaceship or some shit. But yeah, that Shredder is the fucking best version of Shredder. I don't care what anyone says. Donatello and Leonardo and Rachel. And Rachel.
Find him.
My favorite Ninja Turtle. The one with the size and the anger issues who overcomes all of their anger and all of their trauma to be the best version of themselves. Rachel. My favorite Ninja Turtle, Rachel. My favorite artist from the early Renaissance. Rachel. Leonardo, Donatello, Raphael, Michelangelo, and Rachel. Oh, hey, it's this fight. Also, quick fun fact about this fight, by the way. So with the amount of bullshit effects that are happening here, it's still at 60 FPS, but the graphical quality will drop from 1080 to 720. Just so y'all know. I found this out the other day. In this fight especially, the display settings drop from 1080 to 70, but the frame rate is always at 60. On performance mode, graphics mode, 4K hard lock, excuse me, and 30 FPS hard lock. Oh no, the cyberpunk music isn't here yet. That's one big kahuna. I gotta remember that I don't have a ice dodge. Stinger. Ow. This is still my favorite Titan fight. I enjoy this fight more than the Bahamut fight, personally. Although my thought might change. too early. Probably should have done more damage before I started this. Right in the crotch, baby! Let's go! Oh, get the fuck out of here! Whatever. Bitch. Oh, bitch. Uh-oh. Can I even hit him from here? I can. I fucking love this fight, and this is just the start of it.
Let's give this a try.
I thought I missed that, and I was gonna die. There we go. Oh, fuck. Let me... Blech! Yeah, I'll get this real fast. Bitch. Right in the crotch. Where's your swear jar? Ask me in about 5 years. Yeah, bitch! 1, 2, 3. There we go. Give him a taste of the good shit! I'm probably gonna miss this, though. Right in the RE4R. $5? No. Shit, I missed. There we go. He's dead now. Oh, I almost forgot about that. But it didn't matter. And we didn't die. Nah, the boss fight's over. What are you talking about? He's defeated. He's done. He's gonzo. I would love to see what Byron's reaction to this was. Why isn't Byron with us? Ah, oh, this fucking fight. Oh no, Uncle Byron. Yeah, you could see, like, the fucking 30, 20 FPS drop, and then it jumps right to 60. Oh, I have, like, no health. Uh-oh. Maybe this moment right here where I decided that this game was slightly better than Hi-Fi Rush. Call me Uncle Dad. Jesus Christ. Oh no, it was that moment right there. Never mind. It was the moment where Ifrit did a fucking gainer. That's the moment that I decided that this game was slightly better than Hi-Fi Rush. Kaiju doing fucking tricks. I got that one just in time. I'll tell you right now, Jin, they fucking talked to Kamiya. they fucking went to Platinum Games' office, sat Kamiya down, and said, "What do you think we should do?" And he just went, "Kaiju battles." Have you ever heard of a game called Metal Gear Rising Revengeance? Do that. He also told them to put in 4th walking segments, and then they did. Out. I'm gonna heal real fast. I am allowed one. lot of damage. I may as well do this too. Because that's going to recharge very fast. Shit, I could have done more damage. Imagine just seeing this as you go hunting. As you go fishing in the desert wasteland. Oh yeah, here it is. Here's the DMC4 music. Uh-oh. I can't believe I fucking broke that. Fuck you! I bet Link can't do a B-twist. That's what this is. Go boom, boom, B-twist. Ah! Hitbox is still active. I'm gonna do this. Fucking fair. The stagger phase literally started like when he was dropping his hand. How did that not hit you? The hitbox wasn't active. I've said this before, but this is like the savior fight in DMC4 done correctly. I fucking dodged that, come on. Get game is so fucking good. Yeah, exactly. It's just the savior boss, but better. Alright. Just get this while it's here. I could be doing so much more damage. I think this is the end. I know that this is Titan Lost, but when are we gonna fight Titan Found? This fucking video game. I'm sorry, but this is better than the Bahamut fight. In my own personal opinion, I think this is better than Bahamut. This is so fucking stupid, I love it. Get it? Heads up. I kind of want to know what would happen if I didn't hit the cinematic flash. Like, would he just, like, swipe me out of the way and then I would die? Oh, I just realized he did a fucking Beowulf dive kick. He did Killer Bee. So I believe that brings our DMC reference tally up to, I don't fucking know what it is now. Dude, yeah, Burrito, like the Naruto storm battles. Yeah, I agree 100%. That's a really good way of putting it. Oh, fucking A. I forgot about this part. Fuck, I forgot about this part. Like, this man is so fucking angry that he is not done. Ow. I'm hitting him, I don't care. shit, I just realized, like, he is barely taking any damage. Oh my. Oh my fucking god. Bro, the game just gets better with New Game Plus. It just gets better. Second playthrough, like, the second playthrough, I think, is so much fucking better gameplay-wise because of this shit. The fight lasts so much longer. Ow. Alright, I'll give you that one, Hugo. I got him with us. There we go, right in the ass. What you gonna do, huh? What you gonna... Oh, he's gonna do that. Okay. Bro, you missed. Oh! Ow! You, I dodged that shit. One, two. I think it's this one. Bro, he's still not dead. I'm doing like no fucking damage to this guy. Oh my god. Ah! Ah! Giving him a nice little back massage. He's fucking dead! He's fucking dead! Fuck you, Hugo! Oh shit! I hit the wrong one! So that's what happens. I think that's the first time I miss a prompt.
What? Ether from the mother crystal. If you can do it.
I bet my bitrate is absolute garbage right now. However, we done diddly did it. He is dead and I gained like no experience from that. Wow. He's fucking dead. Look at this asshole. Fuck out of here. He was mad, but he wasn't mad enough. I guess you could say he was a mad titan. That's chat after I made that stupid ass pun. Yo, what's up, Magnum? How you doing? Fuck. Clive! Fucking... I get it! Take some fucking DayQuil, Clive! You'll be fine! Take some DayQuil, take some Aleve. Jesus. Burrito, don't you actually mean, me when X?
Is that you, Ultima?
What do you want?
Your soul is tainted with worthless human will, yet your thirst for power remains undiminished. With every sip you take, you grow.
Pardon me, when XF.
And soon you shall achieve perfection.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't forget
about.
To re-X
you
my
will
ex.
Accept us, Newthos. It is inevitable. You were created for this purpose, and you shall
fucking billionaires
serve it.
Never!
Seeing all of the shenanigans on X makes me want to main martial law in Tekken 8.
Fight it, Clive! Don't let him in!
Yo, Burrito, I'll do you one even better. Imagine having back-to-back amazing Square Enix guest characters with this in 15 and Tekken 7 and 8.
Consciousness. We believed we had merely to purge you of your will to claim our vessel. It appears we first have to sever every thread of the consciousness that supports.
Now listen, Harada.
No matter.
I will not ask you for shit, okay? Because Clive is not shit. I will ask you for perfection. And perfection would be having Clive in Tekken 8, along with Daryl Dixon. How about that? See, we gotta keep the trend going. We gotta have the Square Enix rep, and we need to have the Walking Dead rep. Fucking Daryl Dixon.
Thank you.
I would love Daryl Dixon in Tekken 8, actually. Just give me another fucking wacky ass, goofy guest character in Tekken 8, and I'm sold.
One can no more command the power.
Just one bag of pH down, yeah, one bag of pH down should do it.
Then one can constrain the tides by standing in the sea.
Smallville Clark Kent.
Than this, but it seems his head was
anything else? Test strips would probably be fine. Oh my god, it's Virgil!
That man lived only for
this fucking weirdo.
Clinging fast to a fiction, even as it's
yeah, we got ourselves an aquarium. It's been kinda green and shit over the past week, but I've been like finally able to like fix it.
Only the Almighty can do that.
Bro, I was fucking pissed. This whole COVID thing has been pissing me off, because, like, I think it was a couple days ago, it was, like, 90 degrees outside. It was the perfect day to fucking go swimming. And then I couldn't go swimming because I had the vid.
A fool like all the rest.
Oh, I don't know if you were joking or not, Burrito. We got a pool. But as far as the aquarium joke goes, we get occasional flies and bugs. I don't think we've ever had like frogs or anything in our pool yet.
Oh,
nothing like that.
That the death of a mother crystal should be so beautiful.
Actually, no, that's not true. There was like a rat or two, I think, last year. So GT Goku was in there at one point.
some medicine, my lord?
Oh, look, it's Leviathan.
I have salves, potions, anything you need.
Stop bothering me, urchin, or you'll feel the back of my hand.
You must consider your health, my prince. If a show of force is needed to keep the Daleks
at bay... Yeah, my guest character wishlist right now is Clive.
Beg you to call on Bahamut.
Majima or Kiryu, I would accept either of them. Ichiban would also be fine, but, like, I would just prefer the other two.
The Empire agreed to an armistice with the Republic, and yet the Emperor still...
And you know what?
It's ruined.
I'm gonna fucking stick to my gut. I want another Walking Dead representative.
Now the Daleks suspect nothing. And as long as I can hold their gaze, war need not be inevitable.
I used to be a manager for a pet care department at PetSmart.
But more than that, Bahamut is the champion of the Empire.
Garbage company. Ooh, maybe we shouldn't go to PetSmart then anymore. I think we have a PetSmart around the corner. Just because it's there. Gotcha. Yeah. Amanda and I will probably never own any fish for the rest of our lives.
Forgive me, Terrence.
You know what my favorite part about these two is? It's like it was like the fucking meme that Dion's voice actor posted on Twitter. He like did the voice for it where like Dion tells Terrence to go and find Medicine Girl. And he's like, you don't know what she looks like. And then he like draws up like a really stupid looking picture of her and just goes, this is the person that you're looking for. Because Terrence has no fucking idea who this medicine girl is. All right, I'm going to fucking speedrun strat this. You ready for this shit? The fact that I can do this is so stupid. I don't even need to take the goddamn elevator. I could just do that.
You have told me the gentleman you visited earlier.
I'm not gonna lie, as a heterosexual man, that kind of upset me that didn't kiss at the end of the game. You know, I could also agree to that too, because like, I feel like Dion went into that fight knowing that he was gonna die and he was never gonna see Terrence again.
I am. And with glad tidings for once. Hugo Kupka is no more.
Well, all of our comrades.
We had a stallus from. I expect
it's
one for the.
Welcome home.
It's good to be.
I feel it, which means I'm coming.
Alright, now we're gonna talk to you. Hi, Vivian. Bye, Vivian. Hi, Vivian. Bye, Vivian. Hi, Vivian. Bye, Vivian. Good talk. Take care now. Bye bye then. I'm on board with the Dion somehow lived train. Bro, we're talking about how Clive living is a bit of a stretch. But fucking Dion? Burrito, do I need to remind you about what happened with our boy Dion? Do I need to remind you? Do I need to fucking show you the cutscene where Dion, like, tried to nuke Ultima, fucked up, and then, like, plummeted to his death? No, he's fucking dead. I don't care what anyone says. I can humor the whole Clive and Joshua bit, but Dion is fucking dead. I don't need to speak to any of these people.
Blackthorn, what is that?
Oh, that reminds me. Let me fucking,
Well, don't just stand there gawking.
Shut up.
If you're gonna buy something, be quick about it. It's better I'll be here.
Yeah, you're already better than what I currently have. You know what? Fuck you, I'll buy this too.
You're running me blind, you know.
Do you actually have the fucking item yet? Jesus.
The
finished, are you?
I need the actual Phoenix Down item.
Clive, what's that for you, dear?
Let me fucking...
Not my best work, but it'll do. You can thank me later.
Oh, shit. I need a diamond sword. Where the fuck is the diamond sword? Can I... I need... Ooh, I can craft this.
The best work, but it'll do.
Oh, but you shut up.
Yeah, that should do ya.
Blackthorn, do I need to fucking go through the Blackthorn Blues again with you? Like, Jesus. I need a silken slash. Where is the silken slash? Flawless with, what the, excuse me?
That it? Fine.
Alright, and then let me go and talk to Harpocrates. See, my theory is that it was actually Harpocrates that ended up writing the book. Right. Or at least finishing it.
Let's see if Otto has anything else for me.
Like, Clive and or Joshua like started the book, and I feel like, but then, you know what? I'm not fucking talking about it anymore. I like that Clive died. There, I said it.
I'm telling you, it's true.
My head hurts. If y'all watched Arrow, I'm gonna go on a side tangent right now. I've been rewatching Arrow, and I'm on season 5. Which is like one of my favorite seasons, but one of my favorite moments, spoiler alert, is when Oliver is being tortured by Prometheus, and Prometheus is like, he's doing the whole like, you know, confess your sins or whatever. Literally one of my favorite moments in the entire show, where he's like, you didn't have to kill because you wanted, is it because you had to? So why? Why did you kill them? And Oliver just goes, because I wanted to. I wanted to, and I liked it. Like, that's me right now with the ending where Clive was dead, and they're like, you don't have to believe that Clive is dead. So why do you believe it? Because I want him to be. I want him to be dead, and I liked the ending where he died. I wanted him dead. Oh, I gotta do more of these fucking hunts! Ugh. I gotta use the restroom. I'll BRB. And then we're gonna talk more about Arrow and Prometheus and how much I fucking love this show. Oliver, hello! Oliver, don't say anything that'll get me canceled. Nope, Oliver, you're not coming with me. Good boy. All right, anyways, back to talking about Arrow, the greatest TV show on TV. Ugh, why is Arrow always stealing Batman villains? Prometheus is... Well, honestly, like, so Arrow really is just Batman, but, you know, it's the Green Arrow instead. And honestly, I feel like that...
You barely said.
Excuse me, sorry. Oh, okay. I think that, like, the tone of Arrow is what actually made me a Green Arrow fan. And, like, you know, don't get me wrong, like, I kind of like Green Arrow as a character. Like, I've always liked Speedy and Red Arrow as, like, as the sidekick character, because I'm just a sidekick shill. And I'm just a big fan of superheroes who don't have superpowers. But, like, Arrow borrowing pretty much everything from Batman was just such a good fucking idea. Like, it really is just the Batman show without Batman. You know, Oliver, repent for your sins against the Mayonnaise's Instruments community. He's just fucking sitting there, just chewing on his tail. Hey, you should stop chewing on your tail, buddy. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't do that. Have you of course I've watched Young Justice.
This my last shot.
Young Justice is one of my favorite cartoons ever. I enjoy Young Justice more than Teen Titans. There, I said it.
Good.
How, actually, yeah, let me rephrase that. Young Justice is better than Teen Titans until you get to season 3. When you get to season 3, it becomes bad. Skipping all this. They're building a ship. Gather the necessary materials. Okie dokie, here we go. But yeah, so anyways, going back to, like, Prometheus, okay? So, like, I know that Prometheus is a Batman villain, but, like, I just fucking love Prometheus in Arrow. He is one of my all-time favorite, like, villains on that show. Like, he actually, after, like, rewatching season 1, 2, 3, like, skipping almost all of 4, not even almost all of, yeah, almost all of 4, and only watching a couple of episodes, and then going on to season 5, I fucking love Prometheus. Prometheus is probably my favorite villain in Arrow, right behind Slade Wilson. Because the only thing I didn't like about Slade as the main villain was that, like, you know, Slade was a fucking menace to Oliver, but I hated his motivation and, like, the whole Mirakuru thing. And he's like, the only reason I'm trying to kill you, kid, is because you loved a girl that I loved and then she fucking died. Like, I was just, that's the only thing that I don't like about that version of Deathstroke. nah, Marlin. Marlin was my favorite villain. You know, Amanda, Marlin is my favorite villain, too. I know what you meant, but I still love it anyways. His entire premise is his parents were criminals who were killed by cops. He's literally Black Mirror Batman. Okay, now that makes sense. See, like, the thing that I love about, the thing that I love about Prometheus and Arrow, though, is that the reason behind Prometheus's existence is because when Oliver was killing people in season 1, Prometheus, like, is the son of one of the people that he killed, and he just got so fucking angry at the vigilante and Arrow that he became a supervillain. Like he had no reason to be a supervillain, and then he devoted his entire life to just ruining Oliver's life. And that's, like, my favorite shit, you know, because, like Slade's motivation is very similar to where, like, Oliver indirectly got the love of Slade's life killed when he was, like, hyped up on Mirakuru and shit. But Prometheus was just like, oh, you killed my dad? I'm gonna ruin your fucking life, buddy. And then he did. and then, you know what? He did. And, like, Adrian Chase is just such a fucking, like, he's such a, you know what it is? he's such a petty asshole. Like, that's what it is. Like, he is so goddamn petty, and I love it. That's the thing that I love about Prometheus. He is just fucking petty.
That should be enough for now. Let's see how Otto's getting on.
He's just such a, he is just so fucking petty.
Come on.
And I think really one of my favorite quotes that he says is, I'm totally gonna butcher it, but he's like, he's like, he doesn't even know what game he's already playing. And he's already like 10 steps ahead.
How much did you get? Enough.
I fucking love Prometheus. And then it goes back to my favorite meme, which is, when Prometheus is so far ahead of Oliver that he goes all the way around the world and ends up behind him.
Sid will be proud.
That shit is like my favorite meme.
Of you, you idiot. The way you carried on what he's doing.
It'll probably take me 2 seconds to find it. Arrow, Prometheus meme.
Little puppy who enjoyed nothing more than biting the hand that fed you. 5 years on, you're the one doing the
feeding. Oh wow, it's actually taking me more than 2 seconds to find it. Wrong.
You weren't wrong.
Yo, I'm mad. What? This was like my favorite meme.
And thanks to you.
My favorite arrow meme.
When I suggested taking on his name, you were the first to back me. And if you hadn't, no one else would have.
Damn, I failed.
Without you, Otto.
I'm sorry, I failed.
Don't give over. You're making me blush. All I did was choose hope over despair.
But yeah, so I've been rewatching Arrow.
Yes.
And then I got sick with COVID, and so I started watching The Boys instead.
You took a rabble of homeless, hopeless.
And then I rewatched Invincible.
Put them back on their feet.
And I'm so fucking excited for Omni-Man to show up in MK.
Just like the old Sid did.
Makes me wonder what other guest characters we're gonna get. Cause like, each MK had a theme with its guest characters, right? But the last, like, MK11 kind of had, like, a weird theme. Like, you know what I mean? Like the weird thing with MK1 is that Mortal Kombat 1, or sorry, MK11 had, like, a 90s action hero theme, but then it just also randomly had the Joker.
Let's hope this is all Blackthorn needs.
Yeah, it was like 90s action stars. Dude, I fucking wish I liked MK11 more. Because the guest characters in that game were so fucking lit. Like, it was so perfect for me. Like, the 90s action heroes with Arnold, with Sylvester Stallone, RoboCop. Joker, I fucking love playing Joker.
Suppose we'd better be
give us this.
Yeah, comic book villains and anti-heroes. Yeah. That's why we were talking about Shredder. I think Shredder in Mortal Kombat 1 would be fucking amazing, because you know what? It would be fucking amazing because they had the Ninja Turtles in Injustice. Yeah, they had Ninja Turtles in Injustice, so I feel like it would make sense for them to put Shredder in MK. They're able to get Ninja Turtles. Yeah, exactly. And they're all, and it's Warner Brothers, yeah. And he's a comic book villain, so that works. But it has to be 2000 Shredder. No other Shredder. It can't be fucking 90s Shredder. It has to be 2000 Shredder. God, who else could fall into that category?
You'll be pleased to hear that Blackthorn started work on the plating.
Excellent. One down, two to...
A Venom with a Carnage cameo? That would be really cool. I will say, you know what, now that I think about it, I do kind of wish that NRS did somehow manage to make a DC versus Marvel game. Like, I just had a brilliant fucking idea. Okay, so So imagine, if you will, okay? Imagine this with me, okay? Hear me out. So one of the things that I've been saying this entire time, and I've expressed this to other people, is that the thing about MK1 that disappoints me is this fucking cameo thing, okay? I was really hoping and expecting that it would be like 2v2 tag system, like you get to play as two characters instead of this whole like you play as one character and then you just get a surprise motherfucker come out like for a super or a throw or a combo or whatever, right? I am disappointed that it is not like a full tag game, right? Like Burrito's right, it's basically MBC1. But really think about this for a second, okay? Think about fuck that idea and make it an actual 2v2 tag game, but Marvel and DC characters. Like that shit would be so fucking cool. Take the cameo system, like you can still have all the cameo stuff where like you have like the interchangeable throws and whatever, like I think the cameo system is fun, but I would also love the ability to swap out and tag. Like that shit would be so fucking cool. Like imagine if like, you know, you're doing that like fucking you're doing like a combo string or whatever, and then you use your cameo fighter to put the cameo in, but then you like hold the button and then you swap characters. Like that shit would be so fucking cool. And it's like, I just wish they did that. You know? Yeah, Tekken Tag, exactly. Exactly. That shit would be so fucking cool.
Seems Lorbert's pass is our best bet then. What do you say, Togo?
Oh my fucking god. Alright, Amanda's home. Alright, Ollie.
No?
Why? Are you good?
No.
Are you alive?
No.
Okay, bye. I'll just stay in here. Yeah, MK9 actually did have tag teams. I never played MK9, but I knew that it was there. They should just fucking do that shit. It's pretty dumb that after all this time, Jean-Claude Van Damme finally agreed to let MK1 make him into this, even though he said no on the pa- and I feel like if there was a, I feel like he should have done that in MK11. It would have fit with everybody else. Woof. Let me fuck in. Oh, I didn't mean to do this.
What is it to you?
Let me uncompress. Don't you mean decompress? Let me fucking do this. Bro, that did like, oh, they're level 70, that's why.
Don't leave here alive.
Right, let me fucking. Good job, Targal. I'm proud of you, buddy. Oh, whoops. Oh, let me fucking do this, actually. There we go. I just used all my health. Fair enough, Amanda. But yeah, I think that would be so fucking sick if they could do that.
Are they planning an attack on Lost Wing? I need to warn Quentin.
Faster,
Ambrosia. Yeah, I just wish, give me a crossover fighter already. Give me a good one. Give me a good crossover fighter again. I miss it. I miss Marvel. I just want another Marvel game that isn't garbage, okay?
Straight home now.
Oh my god, fucking... No! Can we fucking... kill these things? Just let me fucking hit this. Elite Fighters Combat Pack 2. Bro, enough with the fucking leaks. I am so sick. I am so sick and tired of this modern age of gaming. I really am. I wanna be fucking surprised. It's hilarious what we got in the mail. Amanda, I was gonna say something. Okay, hold on. Amanda, am I allowed to tell them the engagement ring story? Am I allowed to tell them that? MK leaks are notoriously unreliable.
Do it!
Okay. Okay. Yeah, I mean your father. Okay. Okay, yeah, so this is like my favorite story ever, I swear to God. Okay, so first of all, I want you guys to realize this one thing real quick, okay? So, well, I'm gonna die, so realize that. I might need to tell it once this is done, because I cannot fucking concentrate and fight this enemy at the same time. Well, see, here's the thing though, right, Arsene? So, like, normally I take, like, leaks and stuff like that with a grain of salt, but the fucking Combat Pack 1 leak being real fucking pissed me off. Like, I'm glad that, you know, those are the characters that we're getting, but the way that that pack leaked fucking made me so livid. Because that is the... Really, when you think about it, some of the most hype guest characters ever, right? When you really think about it. And the fact that it got fucking leaked the way that it did just pissed me off. Let me do this. So that's why, like, every time I'm here, like, oh, now we have Combat Pack 2 leak. And it's gonna be Shrek, like, I don't wanna think about that right now. Bitch, the game isn't even out yet. The game isn't even out yet and people are talking about Combat Pack 2 leaks. If Combat Pack 2 actually got leaked and those characters are actually real, I want Boom to fucking fire everybody on his staff. Whoever fucking leaked, if someone on the inside leaked it, fucking fire everybody. I'm so fucking sick of that shit. Like, Street Fighter 6 gets announced, and the entire fucking roster gets leaked. Not even a week later. Like, fuck that shit. Oh, no, I gotta rephrase that, RSN, because you definitely have nothing to apologize for at all, right? The thing that I'm frustrated with is just, like, the amount of, it really is just, like, the amount of, like, well, first of all, it is the amount of leaks that do actually happen and the way that they happen, but it's just more, like, it's so hard to, like, get excited about, like, a new fighting game or platform fighter or just, like, anything that's, like, story or video game related. Because, like, we are so what's the word, like, engulfed in this culture of, like, online social media stuff, right? That it's really fucking hard to be surprised, you know? Literally look at Spider-Man No Way Home as an example of that, right? And the thing that just, like, irritates me is that if, let's just say, like, hypothetically that, like, the Combat Pack 2, like, actually did get leaked, I am also very curious, if you don't mind answering, where you heard this leak, or, like, where the leak came from. Because, like, the Amazon one, was definitely real. Like, once I heard that it was, like, the Amazon, like, Amazon leaked it, that's when I knew that this, like, that one was real. So that's where you kind of got to be careful with that sort of thing. But it's just, like, it's so hard to get excited about, like, something hidden like that when it's, you know what I'm saying? I'm going in circles. I think the last time that I was genuinely surprised, fucking Nickelodeon All-Star Brawl 2 apparently was leaked too. That was a thing also. I saw in a video the other day that was apparently leaked. But I feel like the last time that I was really surprised by, like, any sort of, like, fighting game related announcement was Sora and Smash Brothers. All right, where are we going? Yeah, and you wanna know what's fucking crazy? I remember, I think it was Maximilian Dude I was watching. Devil May Cry's a rockin', baby! Yeah, Skull, hello! Thank you so much for the raid, my friend. How you doing? Welcome in, Raiders. I gotta give Skull a shout out real fast. Hold on. Unless Reaping beats me to it. So, we're currently playing Final Fantasy, but we are also bitching about, leaks and stuff. Disney had snipers on roofs during negotiations. No, Burrito. That is not true. Because apparently, according to, I think it was Maximilian Dude, Sora got leaked, I think, the night before. If memory serves, Sora got leaked the night before, but it wasn't like a trailer or anything, but it was like some leak that said that Sora was the final character. It was something like that. I forgot the exact circumstances around it, but Sora did get leaked. I didn't fucking see it, so I lost my shit. But that was the last time that I think I was, like, genuinely surprised by a reveal because nothing got leaked. I still need to gather materials, fucking Christ. Where am I going now? What? Who the fuck am I talking to now? Bitch, didn't I just talk to you?
So, Clive, who will accompany you?
Oh, right. Jill, you're coming with me.
Very well. So then.
I have to...
Okay. Yeah, all right. Story. So here's the story. Okay. So when I proposed to Amanda last Sunday, one of our stipulations was that we weren't going to make any social media announcements until, like, both of our set of parents knew. Thank you, Skull. I hope you have fun at work, dude. Take it easy. I'm also gonna do this because I don't really need to hear any of this shit.
Pooch is nice and chilled.
So we said that, like, we're gonna tell our parents and whatever. And, like, my parents are, like, local in our area, so I wanted to tell them in person, but Amanda's parents aren't local, so she had to, like, you know, message him and whatever. So So she texts her father, and so some quick context about Amanda's father. So he lives in like a very secluded, like, I don't want to necessarily say like middle of nowhere area, but like, was I supposed to buy this? I think I was, yeah.
All anyone ever wants anymore.
And like, you know, he's just what I could describe as a weird dude. Like, I love the guy.
Welcome.
But he can be a weird dude. So so Amanda sends him the picture of her engagement ring.
Take it.
Good readings. That's everything.
Sends him the picture of her engagement ring. And so he responds with a text message that says engagement ring with a period. And nothing else.
Did you find everything?
I did.
And I forgot what their conversation turned
garlic
into afterward. Burrito, that is literally what he said. that is literally what he said.
To keep her engine cool.
What you just typed right there, word for word, with like the capitals and like, you know, the case sensitivities and everything. That is what he fucking sent. And Amanda was like, I'm not gonna respond to him for a little bit. He already knew, so apparently he was making a puzzle. So here's the funny thing though. He didn't know I was gonna propose to her though. He did not know. Not a single person knew that I was gonna propose to Amanda except one of my friends whose name is Jesse. Jesse is the only person who knew that I was going to propose to Amanda. And he helped me like with like setting and everything like that. So he was the only one that knew I was gonna propose to Amanda.
Catch you now, would we, boy?
Yeah.
Was there anything you wanted
but
to yourself over
engagement
there?
Ring.
There was, yes. Well, sort of. Molly in the kitchens told me about a place.
Here's the thing, Arsene. It's definitely not that.
You might like to share one with me.
That's just Ooh. How he is.
Thank you.
It was just the funniest fucking thing. It's a great story to tell. Oh, look at that. Jill made us a picnic.
Big white cobs, like... What do you think? I thought we might...
You're right.
It's just... Clive.
Well, the couple's kissing while the guy's giving a backwards high five with the friend.
To enjoy this.
No, Jill. This is how life should be.
And it's how and like I said, will be I love Amanda's dad. Done. But we can both agree that he's a wackadoo. In the best way.
Thank you.
Was this it? Yeah, there we go. I can skip the rest of this. Okay, let's get the fuck back over to the hideaway. My goal today is to make as much progress as possible so that way I can just do more side quest stuff throughout the week. Excuse me.
Hang on with the moon dew.
And now I think I have a mission with Gav?
Oh, her ship lies still in
harbor. Or I think I have the option to choose between Gav and Otto. I think if I remember correctly.
How's Will? I was just and now that
you can count on me.
What about the work is
apparent.
Thank you.
Right then. Of course.
Skip. Boom. Bro, that's a lot of experience. Level 65. Fuck yeah. Okay. Well. So. Now we need to go... Fucking Christ. Just ruined by the servers. Oh, I'm sorry. Ugh. Yep, giddy up, giddy up. Let me talk to Desiree real fast.
I wasn't expecting.
Oh, that's right, because I have a.
Here you are. All yours.
Take this.
I don't have that one. You do. All done?
I am all done. Thank you. Thank you for that. Yep, giddy up, giddy up. Okay. You know, for my first stream back, after nearly dying last week, I actually feel like this isn't too bad. I'm just starting to get a little sleepy and hungry.
Sorry to keep you waiting, but you'll be pleased to know that work.
You found something.
Yes, mid. Oh my god, that fucking face that I froze on.
You know, when I go into the smithing game, I thought I'd be making swords and shields, not thermal
displays.
Yeah, no. I didn't have it half as bad as Amanda did, though. So big shout out to Amanda for surviving COVID. I also feel like this is the most I've talked in the past week. So my throat's gonna be fucking sore. Do I need to get more fucking materials for you, Mid?
What's the matter?
Nothing. Thinking about the Enterprise sailing off over the horizon to shoals, searching for a land untouched by the Blight. So if the worst came to the worst, that's what she was meant to be. But now she's so close to being finished. I don't want her to be just a... I want people to... In a world where we're not...
I'm working on... And I'll do everything I can to get...
All right. As soon as the Enterprise is fit to sail, I'm putting her under your command. Sod our plans.
Are you sure?
Something tells...
He'd be proud of...
You were...
I was.
Right. So just...
All right.
I...
Get out of here, Mid. It's nothing against you, but you just talked so damn much.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Really? What's a ship?
Jocelyn?
Let's sail it around the lake.
Oh, wait, never mind. That looks absolutely nothing like a ship. I thought... that was going to be a little too mean, I guess. Whereas, like, Mid told me she was building a ship. I'm like, bitch, do you not see the fucking ship?
All right, Clive. Mid finished sent... No, excuses.
Not quite.
She said that.
She...
Clive, were you born yet?
Yeah, and then she's going to be leaving. I'm gonna go accept the side quest real fast. Y'all are not fucking ready for these speedrun strats, let me tell you. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. So I'm gonna go... Oh shit. Here we go. Let me just... Oh yeah, you can counter Verdugo's attacks. It's so nice. Let me just fucking... You bitch! What? That's fucking lame.
Wish I could take my clothes.
Leon is so badass with his backflips. I mean, you're not wrong, but like... You know, Leon's not the only one who can do backflips. I can do backflips. I can be cool too and badass and shit. I can fucking backflip. It's just a backflip, I mean. Ah, Blackthorn's depressed again. Are you Leon S. Kennedy? Look at... Actually, wait a minute. No, I didn't replace the... I did a, like a Leon S. Kennedy photo shoot. That, like, it was like a parkour, like, Leon Kennedy photo shoot. I have the hair and the jokes. Also, I read all of these already, so I don't need to look through them again. Do I need to fucking... I do. Hold on. I may as well do this since it's here.
Blackthorn.
Skip. Thoughts on DMC Ken in Street Fighter 6? He's not voiced by Ruben Langdon, which means it's good. Wait, excuse me?
You're looking well, Ken.
Hello. Oh, yeah. Where's Mid?
Thank you, Oberlin.
Yeah, I did see it. It looked really cool. I can't read this in my Byron voice.
So what? Mid got us to do all the dirty work and then just sailed off into the sunset.
Goddamn right she did, Gav. And that's why you're the best side character. All this fucking busy work. I just want to punch things. You know, we'll watch this cutscene because this was a nice cutscene. Remind me later. I'm gonna have to send y'all a pic in the Discord of me doing the Leon photo shoot.
I remember what you told me. But if no one is listening to what you have to say, you may as well not say it. But I will say this, old friend. Hugo Kupka is gone. His shadow looms over.
He's dead and I killed him.
It's a pity the Phoenix can't be in two places at once. If it had been with us, maybe he could have done something for the Lost.
Never entered your Discord? Really? You should. It's a fun time.
Phoenix can bring people back from the dead. Life has a beginning and an end.
Oh, Burrito. Yeah, you weren't there. When Sid died, I was a fucking wreck.
We have the chance.
Oh my god, that means you can go back through the YouTube VODs and you can see, like, all of the reactions. Hold on, I gotta link that shit again.
Lady Karen.
Now I am the high YouTube.
I thought I'd drop by and see how you were all doing before heading off to restart.
You live long enough. You either die in chat or you live long enough to see yourself become a high YouTube. Yes, that Ryu was me. That was like one of the early, early ones. That's when I was doing like short film production. Yeah, the Ryu was me. I was also the Batman. in the Batman versus Terminator video. That was fun.
It wasn't the most scenic view back then, but it were never as bad as this.
I know. The blight marches on. And soon, there'll be no escaping sights.
Bro,
like
I fucking love Clive's outfit. Cosplaying that has got to be a fucking bitch
so
and a half.
Our mission remains unchanged. We cannot stop until every mother crystal is gone and their thirst for ether with them. The only one that remains in storm is Drake's tail in the crystalline dominion.
Our next target.
We're going to Twinside.
It's the capital of the Empire these days. How unlike to think how tightly guarded they've got the place.
There were a couple of Marvel Infinite tournaments, Injustice tournaments.
If we do well to scout it out before you go charging in.
We would indeed.
I know I have in my like dominion, tournament playlist. There's a DBFZ tournament as well. Please. I think.
Oh, I am sorry. Have you forgotten you're the most wanted man in the Twins? I thought you might like to disguise yourselves as the attendants of a traveling
You know,
trader.
When I actually enjoyed Dragon Ball Fighters, all the way back in season one.
You wanted to buy yourself some tools, didn't you? Well, now's your chance.
You're letting me go with them. Oh, thanks, none.
Stop that. You'll break me bones, you great galoot. There's a caravan that runs back and forth between the Dominion.
Oh my fucking god. Oh no, it's this. Shit. It's this busy work. Oh no. It's like right before the Bahamut fight. But it's this busy work where like Goots loses his pass. Fuck. Bro, there's so much shit I gotta do in this video game. Onward and upward. Speaking of onward, where is my chocobo?
Better. Thanks to Taya.
I'm glad to hear it.
And Torgal helped too. The new boy.
Woof. Good boy. Good bat dog.
This used to be a trade route for merchants crossing the scars. Till the Republic laid a new road wide enough to let wagons pass. And all official traffic moved there.
Leaving this one for those living outside the law.
Indeed. I doubt we'll be the only outlaws on the trail today.
Faster, Ambrosia! Faster! Fucking... Ooh! Doggy!
Here.
What? Wait, Amanda!
What?
Did you let him out?
Straight home now.
No!
Oh, we'd be lucky to make...
Can you let him out?
What?
Why are you looking at me like that? You can sleep, you just gotta let him out first. I did, I let him out right before stream.
Good girl.
But
I'm not sure I trust those
two. About 3.5 hours ago.
If there are bandits lying in wait, I should
probably
take
Amanda.
Care of
them.
Look lively, you lot. Got guests.
Okay.
These must be our bandits.
You worked on that. Oh, that guy did not take any shit. So, there we go. This. Go here. 1, 2. Yeah, you see how Jill did that one attack? That's all she's gonna do for the rest of the fight. Hello, dog. Ah! There we go. Ooh, 140, not bad. Oh, I didn't even break tank cannon. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Okay. This. This. This should probably kill him. Yeah, he's dead. Good boy. Good boy.
That's them dealt with. No.
Oh.
Where's that cart?
We can just go through here, and then I think we just beat these two up, if I remember correctly. Oh, no, we don't beat them up. I thought we did.
I'm motivated.
Yo, Evan, thank you so much for time the resubscription. Yeah, it does. In 4 months. Thank you so much, Evan. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Where am I going? I'm going over here. Okay. Once I get to...
Let's go.
That point.
I see the Dalmex lag behind Rosaria when it comes to bridge building.
I'm gonna take like a quick break to let Oliver out and grab some food. Grab something real fast.
The path continues on the other side.
Actually, let me go through this. Or actually, wait a minute. Is this where... Oh, this is where a cutscene happens. Hmm. Yeah. Actually, let me do this, yeah. I'm gonna let Oliver out real fast. I'll be right back. Sorry for the very brief interruption, but yeah, I'm gonna need to let Oliver out because it's been a couple hours. So I will be right back momentarily. I'm also gonna put on a quick ad as well. But yeah, I'll be back in about like 5-ish minutes, I wanna say. Okay, I'm back. Yes, maybe. Probably. Okay, that was a nice break. It's actually really nice outside. So, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna let this cutscene rock. Ollie did not go, but it is also his, like, feeding time. So... down that one. Buddy, jeez. Good job. Good boy.
So this is Zemeckis.
Good boy.
The land
isn't this the cutscene where,
It's even more impressive than
like,
I imagined.
Dion also finds out that Olivier is like taking control of
long ago,
the capital, basically.
Man was overcome by avarice.
Ollie.
And challenged the gods in a bid to win their power.
I'm really gonna have to do
the final battle took place here.
Ollie.
At these falls. Or so the legend goes. If anyone ever manages to plumb those depths, perhaps we'll learn if there's any truth to the tale.
That the gods emerged victorious.
Ugh, I need hand sanitizer in this
room. Punished
man
for his defiance.
Yeah, for some reason,
by visiting upon him.
Oliver won't eat out of his bowl, but like we have to like start by like feeding him by hand.
Dominance in Paris.
I should actually Google why that is.
I'll tell the truth. I always thought it strange that the dominant and their icons were deemed.
But he'll like start eating out of our hands, and then he will like eventually transition to eating out of his bowl.
Dominant
like
inherited
right now.
The throne. They were admired and exalted, not spurned. Whenever I got to that part of the story, I always assumed there must be something I'd misunderstood.
You had a lot of storybooks, didn't you?
Good boy.
In
good
your
job.
Room, I mean. When we were young.
I'm gonna skip this. Although, if we get to see the cutscene where Dion freaks out, I would also love to see that. And we will. Fuck yeah. Good boy. Good job.
I see the reports are true, Father.
Fucking Olivier just sitting in the chair.
I have. Emperor
Bro, poor,
Olivier
poor
shall
Dion.
Rebuild the Holy Empire of Sambrek.
How is he to rule an empire? He is but a boy.
I shall advise him until he comes of age.
Father, please.
Offer Jesus fucking Christ, poor Dion!
The empire we seek to build needs young blood to rule it. And I can think of none better suited to the task.
Oh, I forgot to mute the mic again. I'm so sorry.
There is other news, Dion. Hugo Kupka is dead.
Actually, and Drake's I do need to wait every 4 hours for this, right?
The pillars of the Republic have fallen. Ere long, the Imperial banner shall fly over every city in storm.
It is every 4 hours.
And then Valisthea. All shall bow before their emperor.
Go boy.
Father, these are the words of a tyrant.
They are the words of a god. The emperor whom I gladly serve. Great Grieger made flesh.
I'm gonna see if he's gonna eat more if I do this. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what I thought, Oliver.
You eat your food.
Yeah, I don't understand this.
Return to your
I should probably deal. Google
and
why
your forces.
This is happening.
It is time to show the world the true power of Sambra.
Father, I find you much changed.
Yeah, Dion is not a happy camper.
Is this truly the path you wish to tread? Or are these the ambitions of another? Of Ultima, perhaps.
What nonsense.
What? Why do you get so distracted that you don't eat?
And my mind only.
It's right there. It's right there. Eat the rest of your food, you hooligan.
For reminding me of certain truths. Regarding the nature of nations, of rulers, and of the divine.
You trust the words of this traitress? She betrayed her country. She slew her husband.
You have ever been an invaluable servant to Sambrek, Prince.
What you doing?
I trust you will continue to serve your emperor
in
years to come.
The canker! Silence! Insolent wretch!
It's like having an actual child,
you
I swear.
You will bend the knee. All else is heresy.
Sire, forgive me.
This audience is over.
All right, Olivier, it's time for the meeting. I don't wanna, it's so boring.
No, not another meeting with silly old men. They're so boring.
Oliver?
I'm hungry, Father. Can't we have luncheon instead?
Allie, what are you doing? You might sense the cat outside the door, actually. Oliver?
Does it pain you that you will not inherit your father's throne?
Come on, come back here, dude.
I have suffered worse.
Yeah, the cat is outside the door. That's why he's growling.
Count your blessings, Dion. For a baseball child
bitch.
To be chosen by Bahamut is...
Sorry, Oliver, that you have to be in the presence of such
you
an awful lady.
You have risen high on his wings. But you shall rise no higher, lest your impure blood stain the throne.
What do you know of my blood?
Her name is Annabella, and she's a bitch. But if you're talking about my doggo, his name's Oliver. Oliver does not like eating his food. Shut up, bitch. Oh, we can all unanimously agree that Annabella is an awful fucking person.
Faster!
Faster!
Infiltrating the Dominion won't be easy with the Imperials on high alert.
No. His Radiance has lost one capital already. We can be sure Sylvester will do everything in his power to hold on to Twinside. His troops are well-trained and increasingly battle-hardened.
Bro, we have so many side quests now. We'd love to see it.
More refugees.
Yo, I just realized we haven't even, like, seen Joshua yet.
To live without the crystal's blessing.
Fucking take that, dude.
Back to the stables, girl.
There are no Oliver, what are you doing, dude?
We have to keep going.
This is where we're supposed to meet Goots, isn't it?
That's right. He said he'd wait for us here after replenishing his supplies. I dare say he'll have finished by now.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap.
Let me carry your goods. I'm cheap, he says. Favorite DMC character? Dante. Favorite DMC villain, Virgil.
Across the water. Come one, come
I just
all.
Like,
feast your eyes.
More specifically, good probably sir. DMC
can
3, Dante.
How much? For a measly crust of bread?
You won't find any cheaper. Not nowadays. They are more than welcome to look.
Bro, how are they not fucking sweating their asses off?
The Empire's unlawful and illegitimate occupation of the crystalline...
He must be around here somewhere.
Where's Goose? He's right there.
I'll take the large one.
Favorite Capcom series that isn't DMC, Resident Evil. Goose. Shortly followed by Beautiful Joe.
I'm so sorry. Don't tell Nan, will you?
Slow down, Goose.
Slow down, Goots. Ooh! Speedrun tech. And we need to go... Oh, not here, but...
Bloody Crimson Cobra. Leave some for the rest of them.
What? Or it's this. Here we go.
Looking to hire a coach? It's 10 million for a two-birder to the Crystalline Dominion.
10 million?
Oh, we're not here for that.
Then I bid you good day.
Wait! Don't go, El. He's me mate.
He's me mate! Oliver, you should just go, boy!
Goots. What are you doing?
Excuse me. Sorry.
I gather Lady Helen didn't send you.
Excuse me, there we go. I forgot to mute the microphone again. I'm so sorry. And she's like, oh no, you lost your passport. We'll find it for you. I am trying. I am trying as hard as I can. And it is not very effective. I'm sorry. Alright.
Out of my sight, wretch.
If you could date any Capcom character, who would it be?
Caravan stops next to the checkpoint. Show them your trading part.
Are you the furniture maker?
Looking for something in particular? Ah, I know he's collared you too, eh? Then I expect you want to know more.
She told me you were leading the hunt for the pickpockets. What have you learned?
For one, hard not...
Damn, you really got me thinking, don't you?
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
You should come with me to the Dominion.
Fish for-
Damn, I don't know. Right then.
Questioning children.
I don't know.
Remember when half the people come-
That's a really hard fucking question.
Excuse me. Do you mind if I ask you some?
Cons. Not be.
I was.
Only thing you've grown up, so guess what?
Sorry.
You little asshole. Fuck, you really got me stumped on this one. I don't know. I'm trying to think of, like, a serious answer, too.
Do you.
What?
No.
Oh, I'm engaged. It's fine. I'm engaged. Amanda can understand. Fuck.
You should come with me to the Dominion.
It's a hard question just because, like...
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
I don't really know if there would actually be any female Capcom characters that I would, like, actually be interested in dating. If the opportunity had presented itself. That's what makes this a hard question. It's just more like I don't know, cause like, you know, we joke around that it's like, oh yeah, like Ada's hot and like Claire Redfield's hot and it's like, you know, lady, you know, whatever. But like, I feel like there isn't really like, there aren't any Capcom characters I would like be interested in taking out on a date. I don't know. I don't know.
He was easy pickings.
He wouldn't. My nana's right there.
Yeah. Wish we hadn't handed over the pass, though. Could use one of those things to get out of this dump.
Chance would be a fine thing. The moment they found out this
list of female Capcom characters.
Introduces to these
charming
characters.
Shit.
Chun-Li, Jolanta, Cammy, Ada, Regina, Morgan.
You can get caught if you want. I'm off.
Hunter,
why am I taking this? You know, this is how. This is how you know I'm fucked up right now.
Jill, you watch these.
Bingo! There it is right there. Ashley Graham. Right. I would take Ashley out on a fucking date. That's. It was like right at the tip of my tongue. I was like, I know there's someone. There is someone from Resident Evil, and I just couldn't think of who it was. Because I was thinking of, like, the big obvious ones, but nope, I would take Ashley on a fucking date. I would take Ashley on a date, and I don't need to think about it a second further. It would be Ashley. I thought you would say a Bayonetta. Well, Bayonetta's not a Capcom character. It's all very, like, subjective, and, you know, it's just, like, based on, like, who we find, like, attractive and, you know, all that shit. But, like, it's totally Ashley. Like, I would 1,000%, if I had the opportunity to take Ashley Graham on a date, I would do it.
Cowards. You will not force another child to do your bidding.
Wait, we're not-
Oh, I remember this guy. He fucking turned to stone. Are you hearing boss music behind you? I'm hearing Pledge of the Demon.
We're on the same side. Like hell we are.
Yeah, I hear Pledge of the Demon right now. That's what it is. You know, Pledge of the Demon is gonna play at my wedding. Along with Friday Night. Friday Night is actually playing at my wedding. Who's gonna tell him that this guy can vaporize him in one go? It's like, Leard, it's like the fucking side quest where, the guys are like, hey, we're gonna fucking fight you and spar with you, and you, like, just demolish them. Machine gun kiss before, after the reception. Along with 24 hours Cinderella. My wedding is gonna be fucking lit. It is gonna be lit with all of the fucking nerdiest shit. It's gonna have Yakuza music, DMC music. Like I said, Friday night. One of my really good friends actually, he basically said that, like, all the groomsmen should learn how to do the Friday night dance, and I was like, yo, that is exactly what I'm fucking doing. Hey, Oliver, Oh, look at those guys. They're like, hey, who the fuck is this guy? Let me hit him with the... Yeah! You should have minded your own. No, Clive, go to the different one. And then let me do this. Oh, he's too far away. Oh my god, they all fucking... What happened to them? There we go.
I doubt these were the ringleaders.
But at least we know we're on the right track. Good god.
Oh, I don't know if I mentioned this to y'all, but, like, so there's actually... You can Google this, because I'm in the middle of playing video games, but, like, there are actual Kiryu and Majima, like, wedding bands that you can get. and I showed them to Amanda, and she said that we could have them for our wedding bands. Now this was like a couple months ago, so hopefully she hasn't changed her mind. But like, I think it might actually happen.
Fewer now.
Street Fighter 6 Cammy? Oh no, not at all. Alright. Excuse me. But let me fucking...
Fuck. It's that guard from Fockland. Kill him.
Bitch.
Kill them all.
This is so dumb. Now fucking... No, Clive. No. Bad Clive. Fucking stop. Bad Clive. I dodged that. I don't care what anyone says. This, hit him with that, hit him with one of these. Bitch. Oh my god. And then this should... Get him, Torgo! God damn, dude. I probably didn't need to do this, but it's fine. He'll die anyways. Dress up as Kiryu for your wedding? Nah, I can't do that. Although I do want Amanda. We've already talked about this already, but like, our wedding colors are probably going to be pink and red. That's probably what it's gonna be. I will tell y'all what I wanted to do. I'm pretty sure I have mentioned this before. But one of the things that I wanted to do for my wedding was I wanted to, like, you know, when everyone's like walking down the aisle for, like, you know, they're like lining up and everything, I actually want to be there like last, minus Amanda, of course. But what I wanted to do is I wanted to like start from, like, you know, like a point up there. And then zip line my way down to the down to the podium. That is what I wanted to do. And Amanda for many years has said no. But I have 2 years to convince her otherwise. And I also need to convince our wedding venue to actually put in a fucking zip line. Excuse me. Who's gonna be your best man? Dante, that's for sure.
Right then. Let's get this back to Goots.
And then it's on to the Dominion.
We're not deciding our wedding party until like a year from now, probably. Cause we decided on a 2 year engagement. Excuse me. We decided on a 2 year engagement. But just kind of like looking through all of the like weddings that we've seen or been a part of in the past or whatever, like one of the things that Amanda and I like collectively agreed on, because a lot can happen in 2 years, is that we don't want to decide our wedding party like right away.
Any idea what?
Because then if, you know, something happens or whatever, or just like we change our minds, you know, about a person, or just, you know, better fit, whatever, right? New people come into our lives all the time.
Hurry, man.
We want to, like, be kind of open for that sort of thing. hey, what are you doing? No. Nuh-uh, it's my stuff. Come here. No mas. I've never seen Crazy Rich Asians, actually.
Sounds simple enough.
So you won't old free and you let them know. And I'll give you your little something.
I'll be right back.
Hold on. Excuse me, I am so sorry. Ugh, that was a bad one. This vid is killing me. Ollie! Yeah, I think he wants to leave, but I think Amanda's still sleeping.
Let me carry your goods.
I keep forgetting to mute the microphone. I'm so sorry. Oh, shit. She's talking to me, but nothing is coming out of her mouth. Okay.
Come on, come on.
Potter, Harry Potter. Potter.
What I really want to be is a blacksmith.
You're gonna do an apprenticeship or something, then?
Goots, answer the fucking question. Goots is like, I'm going to be a blacksmith. He's like, oh, you're gonna apprentice or something? And Gooch is just standing there like... He's waiting for the donation to where he can actually make a an NPC noise again. Gooch is gonna hit him with the good old ada ada. Okay, so... Oh, I did learn that, didn't I? You know what I just realized? I need a fucking achievement. Hold on. Let me get this one. This one's gonna be easy. There we go. I really... would like to fuck around with more of these abilities. I just like the way that that move looks, like where he does the cartwheel into the pool. Is that Ollie? Oh no, that's not Ollie, that's a different Ollie Oliver. I thought that was you for a second, dude. But that's not you, that's a different dog. Earth and Fury. Diamond Dust. Bro, like, I love how, like, literally the entirety of Odin's moveset is just revolved around Odin. That's so unfortunate. Because, like, you can't really, like, except maybe Rift Slip. I saved, right? Yeah, I did. See you later, nerd. With the tornadoes, it makes it super hard to see boss attacks. Oh, yeah, I imagine. You can have any right. Capcom character powers, but we have a place I just start charging for these questions. These are some deep questions. But you also have to fight their enemies whose powers you have.
We're mercenaries.
You know what, Virgil? That'd be a fun fucking fight.
Mercenaries.
Ugh. Remember the plan. You're to ride all the way to Twinside. Jill and I will go with you as far as the outskirts.
I keep thinking that's Ollie, but it's not. It's a different dog.
I'll buy that stuff.
Oliver, is it you?
Right.
Is it you?
Scout out the Imperial's defenses.
No, it's not you. That's a different dog.
Bell tower right in the middle of town. If you get lost or out goes wrong, we can meet up there.
Right. Let's go.
Okay. So... Yeah, this is right before Bahamut, isn't it? Yeah. It's a good thing I saved. But I wonder.
I see. And you're quite certain your father has no knowledge.
Sorry, my brain control all deleted for a second.
I am. I have no difficulty believing a sinister force has come to exert an influence on
a giant ice cream in the sky.
Be that as it may.
You were not wrong there, Chief.
Has yet to claim my father. For better or worse, his radiance speaks his own mind. Then the fiend works from the shadows. I confess, when first you told me of this fiend, I had my doubts. And more than a few at that. A beast that labors to plunge Valisthea into turmoil.
Yeah, the fact that we're still, like, brother. Kind of... Like, we're, I think we're about halfway done, technically, at this point.
Then I have your answer, Your Highness. You will join me in my fight.
Because we don't even have Joshua in the party yet still, but after this mission we do.
I cannot. Not yet. Your Highness, please. As you are aware, the Dalmechian army is at our gates.
Because then after Bahamut, we have to fight Barnabas like three fucking times.
Negotiated withdrawal.
So this is about the halfway mark. I think we're like slightly above halfway.
Bahamut is not here to meet them.
I forgot where the halfway meme is. For us, anyways.
Though not by Hugo.
Oh shit! I'm so sorry.
Ultima's machinations. I know the fate of your people weighs heavy on your.
I am probably gonna cut it after this cutscene, though. To Ultima's plans, at least for this part. Fate.
The chaos he would wreak would sweep all of Valisthea into the abyss. Lives of every man, woman, and child in the Twins are at stake. I believe what you say, Phoenix. But I have duties of my own, and I must discharge.
Yeah, this, those are the talks next door.
Come what may.
You know what I just realized? Dion refers to every dominant by their, like, dominant name. He calls Joshua Phoenix. He calls Clive Ifrit. I feel like he's the only one that does that, minus like Ultima.
Of the highest
officers,
he's
so
of state,
like official.
Likely belong to those of purer breeding.
This fucking bitch.
Alas, your bloodline runs through the Oriflamme gutter, from a whore who weighed her child's worth in gil.
Have you threatened my father?
Of course not. I merely whispered in his ear that his mongrel son is plotting a rebellion.
What?
Sylvester listens to the words of his astrologers. And they have ears too.
You have been feeding them your lies.
Should you?
So wait a minute. I can't remember if we talked about this before.
Crown your head with
is
laurel.
Dion's mom just not kind of like a random?
Fork-tongued witch!
In consideration of your long years of service to the Empire, I shall forgive this uncharacteristic rudeness. Now hurry and make ready. Your Imperial Highness.
Interesting.
Emperor Olivier expects much of you, Dion. Or should I say, of Bahamut.
Her death was not brutal enough. It unfortunately was not, but it was very appropriate for her horrible character.
Till all of Valisthea bows to its rightful ruler.
God, hyped when that fucking kid got smoked. Oh my god, when he like, I was like, bro, Dion, what the fuck are you doing? And then Ultima popped up. I was like, oh. I was like, oh, suddenly things make a little more sense now.
There is another darkness that has taken hold of Sunbreak. And until its grip is released, the flames of war shall spread ever wider, just as Ultima wishes. Forgive me. My family has caused you much.
Yeah, big shout out to Medicine Girl. 10 out of 10. We'll probably get a Leviathan DLC.
This is a matter for the Imperial
totally,
household.
Totally what's going to happen. Household,
it falls to me to resolve it. At such time as that is done, what strength I have shall be
there
yours.
There is an evil within this place. Fucking A, I still got to finish the DLC. If I'm able to play something tomorrow, I will probably do that. I'll probably finish the Evil Within
Thank
DLC.
You. Your Highness. Let us take to the skies together. And bring a new dawn to Valisthea.
Also, I just want to, just while I, like before I forget, more. Fucking A, tomorrow's supposed to rain. Shit. Bro, shout out to Terrence.
Terrence.
My prince.
Tell me true. Do you believe what I'm about to do is wrong?
We Dragoons have but one leader, Your Highness.
And I don't think it's ever confirmed, like, which he is, but Terrence is his, like, lover, I think is what it says in the character thing.
For their crimes against the crown, the traitorous Annabella.
But I don't know what his,
shall be put to death, and the Empire restored.
Oh my god, why am I blanking on the word? Is, thing. Shit, well, it is a good thing that I fucking saved before all these cutscenes, huh? Because this is just gonna force me right into this. Well, actually, wait, no, I'm an idiot. Because then I can... Because I can skip this. And then I can skip this. And then I can probably back out of this mission, right? And then I just have to rewatch all the cutscenes again. Hey, that's what I thought. Yeah, fuck you, buddy. Redgrave 1, video game 0. All right, so we're gonna save again while we're here. Just so we don't have to watch all that shit again. Blue Eyes White Dragon. Does Blue Eyes White Dragon count as a pet? Oh, fucking A. Why didn't I name my dog Blue Eyes White Dragon? Okay. I'm gonna safety save real fast. Damn, so much progress was made today. I'm gonna fucking trip this guy. Wow, we did so much shit today. And then we get to start fresh with the fucking, oh my god, with the fucking Bahamut fight. Bright and early next stream, or next episode, we just start right with the Bahamut fight. What I gotta do is put Bahamut in the thumbnail again, and then that's gonna be hype as shit. Wow, so yeah. So it looks like I have my fair share of side quests to do, which is going to be great. And I have not only a lot of side quests, but I have a lot of like hunt activities to do as well, which is going to be real nice. So, good shit. I don't think it's been 4 hours of me playing Final Fantasy because I did the unboxing earlier. But we are going to call it here. So, yeah. Awesome. So, if you made it this far, I just wanted to say thank you again so much for watching. And again, I apologize for the sickliness. But I'm hoping that that is going to feel much better by the time the next episode happens. So we'll see. I'm going to be keeping up on my Dayquil and my Nyquils and all my medicines and stuff. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Comment below, let me know what your favorite parts of the playthrough have been so far, or any other thoughts that you might have. Leave them down below. Thank you again so much for watching, and I will see you next time.